Hello everyone, how are we all doing? Welcome, welcome, welcome. That is not an L, Chris, it was a joke. Which was based partially on facts, but that's beside the point. That's not relevant. It's not relevant. That's what I'm telling myself anyway. Hang on, there's the announcement. I was just waiting because Comic Con Manchester was like, hey, we're going to announce a guest tonight. Who have they announced? Because it was meant to be at 7 o'clock, they were a bit late. Oh, it's Chandler Riggs. Well, that's cool. Carl out of The Walking Dead. I mean, I've already seen him across a crowded room at Liverpool Comic Con. That kind of does me. Plus, I'm too poor anyway, so I don't even think I'm going to be going to that convention. I don't think so. I don't know. Anyway, hello. I've got shit in my glasses, bro. No glasses, Troy. Reveal. I mean, I think most of you've seen me without glasses at some point, but I need to just should have done this while the music was playing. What was that first song? It was meant to be like, I can't read anything in the chat. It was meant to be just like the instrumental intro to Sonic Riders Zero Gravity, and then this dude started fucking singing. I know there is like a lyric version of the song, but that's like halfway between the lyric version and the main menu version. I don't know what the fuck it was, but the weird like kind of echoey vocals, I was just like, nah, I'm good. So I just changed it up. On the fly? Oh, I can see again. It hard. What's hard? What do you think about Dark Souls? Oh, very difficult, probably not gonna do it. Why did you shit on your glasses? Wow, look at you. You're so clever.
Ralph?
CM!
Boner.
Had to, you know, mute the music to hear that crisp audio. Thank you for being the first sub of 2022. No, just of March. I don't know where my brain's fucking going. My head just isn't functioning anymore. I've lowered the sub goal because we didn't even meet 50 last month. And partially is down to Dom. Obviously did do it, like, dump his subs like he normally does. You know what Dom's like, he's a fucking king. But he dumped more tier 3 gift subs, I think, last time. That's probably why there were less overall. Which doesn't really matter because it still helps me get the money that I need to, you know, survive. But I thought we'll set a lower sub goal and see if we can make that and go from there. You know what I mean? But yeah, I thought you'd appreciate me mentioning that you were in episode 3 of Who's There, which I'm going to be hopefully editing tonight after the stream. But we'll see. Imagine being good at Dark Souls. Bro, I said this on Twitter. If a game's going to be super challenging like that, I'm probably not going to play it on the realist level. It's not my thing, you know? Did you end up finding the pick of the big Among Us guy from Comic Con? I didn't. And I know I saw it on Twitter, but it's gone. It's gone with the wind. So, ladies and gents, we are going to be playing a bit of Minecraft today. My logic is this. I've said to you already that we need more kind of series to play, or to stream, I should say. And my logic kind of is, obviously, as we've said, the Twitch is not doing as well as it used to. I want to try and get us back to where we used to be, but I don't have as much motivation to stream as I used to. I still like streaming, but I just feel like I haven't got as many ideas as I used to. So I want to do more series. I think that'll definitely help. And I think one thing I would really like to do is have a Minecraft world I could go back to every week, every couple weeks, and just add more to it. Now, the thing that we did last time when I did this, obviously, was I made it multiplayer a few weeks in. And I honestly regret that. What, two bots back to back? Fucking hell. Would you look at that? Jeez. Well, at least we got enough viewers to get a couple of bots raiding us. That's nice. That makes me feel better. But, of course, you have a Liara skin. Yeah, I found a Mass Effect skin pack was still in the current version of Minecraft, so I bought it. It was only £5, so you can allow it. There were a lot of Mass Effect skins. So I might change them across the stream, but I thought I'd start with Liara for obvious reasons. Making it multiplayer last time, I feel like, was a little bit of a mistake, only because it wasn't a server, so people couldn't add things into it, you know, when I wasn't online, and I wasn't going to start paying for a server, because money, unnecessary costs. But also, once people had kind of loaded in and done their own stuff, that means every time I streamed, it'd have to be multiplayer, and then there'd be different people logging in, and some people wouldn't be able to work certain streams, and it just didn't really work logically for me. And I think personally, even though there is less fan interaction, what I'm thinking of doing is trying to come up with some way that people can still interact and get their ideas into the world without making it multiplayer. So I'm thinking something along the lines of, you know, if you do gift a couple of subs during a stream, you can suggest a building that I put up and build in the world. I haven't decided completely yet. We're going to get started today. I'm not going to introduce anything like that just yet. But I welcome ideas because I want to keep it single player. I think that'll be better for a series, but I also would like to still have the chat give ideas. I don't want to be to be completely disconnected from the community. Do you know what I mean? So whatever ideas you lot have got for how we can include the chat and involve them more in certain decisions, I will appreciate. Anyway, let's play. Anyone got any particular seeds they want to see me use for this world? This is going to be very important. We're starting out on peaceful. I don't care who says anything about it, purely because, like, I just can't be fucked with hunger. Like, I'll turn on the difficulty later. I've said this before. I have no concern over the fucking difficulty of the game with, like, combat and stuff. I don't give a shit. But the hunger in Minecraft genuinely pisses me off. Because it takes you out of the world, I feel like. You're too busy trying to look for fucking food when you want to just be building and mining. That's just me. And I know people will go, oh, you're such a wimp. You won't play on... I genuinely don't give a fuck about the mobs. I don't. I would quite happily play on normal slash hard if the hunger wasn't such a pain in the dick. That's literally it. If they got rid of hunger, I'd play on normal constantly. I honestly feel like it. Because it makes the world feel more lived in. But I'm going to get some food first and not going to rush to do it. And once I've got a decent amount of food, then I'll up the difficulty. Fair enough. Okay, so we're going survival. We're going peaceful for the time being. World type infinite. Yeah, what's our seed going to be? Just Minecraft? Okay, just Minecraft. Don't force difficulty. Exactly. Like, games are meant to be fun. That's why I don't play stuff like Dark Souls. I played a smidge of it and just couldn't get into it. If games are too challenging, oh, hang on. Let's include Elian's number. 3, 4, 8, 7, 1, 2. 4, 8, 7, 1, 2. And if that was like for some kind of prank, me putting Minecraft at the start all messed up anyway. So there we go. I've included two chat suggestions. One person said Minecraft. One person gave me a series of numbers. Now they're both in there. Simulation distance, 10 chunks. Friendly fire won't matter because it's not online, but whatever. Show coordinates, fire spreads, TNT explodes. We're all good with all of this. I'll put some music back on in a minute. What experiments do we want to turn on here? Do we want any kind of experiment? I don't know. Because some of these, it's like, oh, you know, well, like, it means that certain things won't work at, like, after updates sometimes, possibly. So I don't know how much we want to add in. What do we want to add here? What do we want to add? What do we think? Do I need to add anything here? I probably don't, but... What's the wild update? Good question. I have no idea. Maybe that's like a future update and it's like an early version of it. I don't know. Fuck it. Well, fine as it is. Right, not multiplayer game. We don't need resource packs or behavior packs. We're good on that front. It's a future update. Well, I could turn it on, but would that fuck up? You said, I'm kind of thinking that might fuck up the world when there's an update in the game properly. Because sometimes using these can kind of break saves when you go to load them up in future versions of Minecraft. And I don't want that to happen on a stream world. So. What do we think? Is it a good idea to activate or just leave it off? It's a bit unfinished now. Yeah, I think, yeah, we'll go without it. And then that way it'll be cooler when it actually gets properly released. Yeah? Yeah. Let's do that. And then we'll just go with it as is. Alright, so. Do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get rid of Twitch stats on my screen. Because I feel like part of it these days is me looking at the live viewers and it gets me down seeing when there's not as many people here. So all I'll ask is that people who are here, you know, say things in the chat. Because once the chat gets too quiet, that's when I'll know and I'll be like, oh okay. That's when I'll know there'll be less, there's like less going on. And I'm going to be honest with you, right? I know DMCA is a bit of a bitch, but I kind of want to just put on my own music in the background, really, really quiet and not give a fuck. Like, what do we think? Do we think I should just be ballsy? Because I really fancy having Dawn FM on in the background while I'm playing Minecraft. I don't know. I'm just kind of... I don't know. What do we think? Fuck the VOD. Yeah, I might just do that and just hope that I don't get claimed. If I get claimed, then, well, Twitch can suck my dick. And I've just said that publicly, so... Fuck it. Suck you. Fuck off, Twitch. Screw off. Right, nice and quiet. How quiet is that? I don't know. I don't think Snip is working. I don't believe Snip is working. There we go. We could put... Do we even need Snip on right now? Do we actually need Snip on? I don't know if we do. Like, do you need to see what song is playing? Probably, maybe. I don't know. Where do you want it? We could put Snip, like, here, maybe? And then I could extend the black box here. Move that down and just put it over here. Boom. There we go. That works. Fuck. The problem is it snaps into place in certain like alignments on my Twitch and I'm like, no, don't move. I'm like, I like it where it is. Hopefully the text there will be a small enough size that it's fine. I don't know. Play easy by year and the game. I don't know who they are. If they're Kanye West, then I don't want to know because Kanye West is a fucking... strange person. I've heard that his latest music video shows him like decapitating Pete Davidson or something. That man needs serious clinical help. I've never really liked Kanye West, and the more I see about him, the more it proves to me that I was not mistaken in having those opinions. He's a fucking weird person. Do not like him. And ignore me to his list for all I care. So, I mean, not that he ever would. He's not going to be watching my fucking streams. Jesus. Right. Hello, Mr. Twitch here. We haven't been informed about a recent statement you made of a request for you to pay us 8 million Russian rubles. Russian rubles? No! I'm not paying you Russian rubles! Imagine dissing the goat. Yeah, because he fucking looks like one. Got him! Got him! Fucking got him! He doesn't even look like a goat, but he is annoying. Don't ever call Kanye the goat. He is not a goat. Not in any way, shape, or form. Rubles are worth, like, nothing right now. Yeah, hasn't, like, the value of the like Russian currency just gone through the fucking down the shitter? I wonder why. I wonder why. I will say something, though, before we start making any kind of jokes like that. We're obviously not going to be making any jokes at Ukraine's expense. You guys know I like a bit of dark humor, but I don't like anything that's overly offensive. And there is, obviously, a serious situation going on over there, so I don't want to be rude. You know what I mean? So, ruble is worth less than a single Robux. How much is a single Robux worth in, you know, like, British currency? What's it worth? Can I take the piss out of Russians? I think just better not commenting about the whole thing, realistically. I don't know. Is that just me? I don't know. I've just realised we spawned in and I did have a bonus chest and I didn't use it. 1 ruble is equivalent to £0.0068. Oh, fuck. Lol. Shit, where did I spawn? Oh, no. Imagine if I died then. Imagine if I died. I'd have just lost it. I'd have gone mental. I'd have gone crazy, gone stupid. Okay. How are we going to go about this? I have no idea. I might just turn that down a teeny weeny bit more. Just a little bit. He lives. Yes, because I'm strong, man. Single Robux costs 0.0125 GBP. Wow, so it like about... So 1 ruble, 2 Robux is like 1 ruble. Damn. Currency ting. Have you tried mining and or crafting? Well, we are technically mining right now without a pickaxe. We're mining trees. Can you mine a tree? I don't know. I'm not sure. Feel free to answer questions that science could not. Oh, I don't know. Probably should make a new video on YouTube. You know what I mean? I probably should. I feel like I'm kind of a similar issue with YouTube right now as I am with Twitch. I kind of feel a bit more disillusioned than I should be. Because I said I was going to do loads of uploads on Cosmic, and that's not happened. I don't know. I think in my head I know what's coming, and that like pretty soon I'm going to be getting a job. I'm still kind of wondering what to do. I think I've got a couple of ideas. I'm going to do my supply teaching, like I said. I think that's probably going to be a good shout. But I've also found a good tutoring website online that pay you a decent amount to just teach people maths. That might be also quite nice. I've done that before with like a family friend and I really enjoyed it. And I helped her get her maths grade up, which was really sweet. I think her grade improved like 1 or 2 levels, which is really nice. It means that I actually did have a good effect. Which is, it's nice, it's heartwarming, you know? And it tells me that I'm actually decent at tutoring. So I think that might be quite good. Payday to update day soon. This is the thing, that's what I was gonna say. Like all I've done recently is brain fart. Is do videos for Payday 2 updates. And, I mean, I was expecting the Payday 2 update for the new heist map to be releasing this week, but that didn't fucking happen. They did also, didn't they say on Twitter there was a new developer update? I mean, that hasn't released. So, fuck knows what Overkill are doing right now. Maybe they just released that DLC pack. The last one just went, fuck it, put off you up for a few weeks. Don't know. You gotta help me out. I don't know what a math is. Pay me and I'll teach you. Payday 2 update day soon, free content. Exactly, yeah. So, I'll make a video, obviously, whenever that DLC releases. When that is, though? Who fucking know? Wow, okay, that text is not... That text is too big. Great. I kind of hoped that it might be a bit smaller than that. But, right. There we go. I don't believe there are any song titles longer than that one. But if Snip wants to prove me wrong, feel free. Little snippy bitch. There we go. Hopefully that'll do it. This time it's a heist update vid, loud playthrough vid, and solo stealth vid. That might be what I do, to be honest with you. I don't know. I mean, I'll obviously do a solo stealth. Hopefully we'll record that live on stream whenever it releases. Because that makes my life 50 times easier if we can do it on stream. It makes it a lot easier to record the content because I can just re-upload a Twitch VOD. Very, very nice. Is that lazy? Yes. Do I give a fuck? Absolutely not. So that's a goal. Loud playthrough, I don't tend to do as much, but maybe I could? Question mark. What would be nice is if Overkill gave me access to an update like that early. Because they often, like I said, they often will tell me ahead of time when an update's coming out. but I don't really get access to the builds. And that's one thing that I would love if the partnership allowed me to do. I don't know whether they're working on this in the background, because I think they did say they were looking to make the partnership more like have more benefits and stuff. That's not like something I can reveal as like a secret thing. I'm pretty sure they've said that they're just going to see if they can do to make it better. Because it is still, even though the partnership has been going now for 2 years, it's been 2 years since they announced it. Fucking hell. Even though it's been about 2 years since they announced the partnership, they've always said it was in early stages and they added anyone else new to the partnership. They're probably looking to improve it before they add more people, which they definitely should do. I think if they add in more people currently before they add more features and stuff, it might be a bit strange because they've not really changed it too much since the partnership started. At least I don't believe so. That's as much as I can say, obviously, with without breaking NDA. Because obviously there's certain stuff I've signed an agreement not to talk about. Nothing serious, but you know what I mean. You want to be careful legally. But I feel like there's definitely things they could do to make the partnership better. And that's one thing. For me personally, because as a lot of you know, my main thing is the news. So my main concern is getting a video out as quick as possible to tell people what's in the update. I do like more recently when I've occasionally made videos just talking about what I actually think of the update and actually breaking down my experience. But that's only because Overkill have never told me ahead of time and I've just had to respond off the cuff, which gives me mad anxiety. And I've made them that clear with them occasionally. Like, I'll be honest, the last update I messaged them and went, not knowing anything, that stressed me out. Even not knowing an hour ahead. Seeing people say Payday was getting updated, because I don't open Steam. This is the thing. I'm not like most PC players or just gamers in general where they've got Steam open and they'll see an update. I don't open Steam unless I have a reason to. So when I'm finding out there's an update because other people are talking about it, I'm like, oh, shit, what? You know, finding out, like, the common people. Sarcasm, obviously. Well, this is nice. I'm glad more people are in the chat at the minute and talking, because it means I actually have to scroll up to read what I've missed. So I appreciate that, people. Completely unrelated question, but what editing software do you use? Kind of want to get into content creation or something. Vegas Pro... Trying to hover over the icon to get the number. I think it's 16. Vegas Pro 16. AKA CrashSoftware.exe. Who's your vote for the next partner? Because it's definitely your decision alone. If I could pick somebody? I don't know. There's a lot of creators out there. I think their idea with the partnership was to try and go for more unique people. You know, people who come from different countries and do different content. Because, I mean, think about it. Every person they picked so far is of a different nationality. You got a Brit, an Australian, a German, and an American. So maybe someone... I mean, there's obviously big creators out there right now that could get that connection. But I think maybe someone different, possibly. Are there any, what other kind of nationality content creators are there? It'd be good to open that kind of field a little bit more, maybe. Maybe, a Japanese content creator or some more European ones? I don't know. There was a fox getting the shit beaten out of them from behind you. Or was that? I thought I heard a noise a minute ago. What was it? I thought I saw a wolf. Did a wolf eat a fox? Is that what happened? That's fucked. Most of the content creators around Payday may be, no, so Overkill friendly. Not so Overkill friendly. I think it depends, you know? I mean, there could be, this is purely speculation, there could be creators that they reached out to when they first launched the program who didn't get back in touch with them. Because, I'm presuming I can reveal that I was asked by email to join. I'm sure I can say that. If I can't, then whoops, rip partnership. But, I was contacted via email. So who's to say they didn't contact other people and they said no? I don't know. And it's not like I'm going to ask them to go, so, was I your first choice? Was I obviously the best Payday content creator out there? Obviously, you asked me before anybody else, didn't you? I was just fucking grateful they asked me. To me, that was a huge thing. I was like, holy shit, they want me to be a partner with them? I was like, what the fuck? I rode off that wave for fucking days after they asked me. I was buzzing. Even my mum was, which I thought was quite cute. She was proper excited for me. Troy just breached NDA. What, for saying I got emailed? Well, rip. It's nice knowing your partnership. Nice knowing you. What can you do? But yeah, so I don't know. So my that's the point I was trying to make about 5 minutes ago, as I always do, is I would personally like to see, first off, the partnership get a few improvements to how it works. I'd like there to be a consistent, heads up amount of time as to when we get updates. I feel like that's really important. Because like I said, it's what I always say. Sometimes they tell me ahead of time when there's going to be a new update. It's not consistent. It's not reliable. And that's why people make jokes going, did Troy know about this update ahead of time? The answer could be different every time. Sometimes I might know 20 minutes before, sometimes I might know 3 hours before, sometimes I might not know at all and find out after it's released. And it's just that lack of reliability that I would like to see improve first. Because for most content creators, it doesn't matter as much, because they're going to either stream it. Like for Rob, for instance, I hope he doesn't mind me saying this, but for him, his main priority is streaming the content. So it doesn't really matter to him if he gets the build early or not. He might say it'd be cool to get it early so he can practice it before he streams. That's valid. But from a sense of urgency and wanting to get content out as fast as possible, it doesn't impact him. Whereas for me, where I'm like, here's the news, early access would help a fucking shit ton. You know what I mean? Like, news is kind of my edge. I know Noli's kind of been doing that a bit more recently. But, like, his is more kind of a, I've played through it, here are my overall thoughts, which is why I like doing the news, like, quicker. Because I get out the initial thoughts on what's actually in it and what I think it looks like, whereas Noli's like, I've played through it, here's what I think. Which is why when I've done more full reviews, you could even say I was more similar to Noli's content, but it just depends on the time frames, you know? With Payday 3 Overkill Partner, we'll get a fix, just a thought. Oh, like, that's the thing. Everything's still improving, you know? This is a company that nearly went bankrupt, like, 3 years ago. So, they're never going to be perfect. Look at consoles to tell you that much. Every time there's an update, I still get comments being like, oh, look, another update not on consoles. I've just stopped addressing it now, only because I'm just saying the same fucking thing over and over and over again. Do I need to say every update this is for PC? Maybe I should, as like someone who used to be there for console people. Well, I say that, I still am there for console people, but Overkill aren't. So it's like, what am I meant to do? What am I meant to do? They did make a Payday build for Overkill Partners to play stuff early, but it hasn't been updated for a long time. What do you want about? How would you know this? This is intriguing information. How would you be aware of this information? I love going on Payday Twitter, man, and reading no console update again. You get so many people saying it. And I can't blame them, for the record. I cannot blame them. Because I have never seen a game dick over console players as much as Payday 2 has. And I'm not saying that in a malicious way, to say that Overkill have deliberately chosen to do that. Because as we know, that's not the case. But I don't think I've ever seen console get dicked over as hard as a game than with Payday 2. Sadly, like that is just an issue with Payday 2, but... That's a big guy who speculates and watches every Overkill move. It's in the Steam database. Oh, well, there you go. Well, maybe they are working on something for us then. That you might know more than I do, which would be ironic. I don't know. Do you know what I mean? I don't know. The good thing is, like these are things I've already suggested to them and, like, kind of vocalized to people in Overkill. It's not like I'm saying anything behind the back and going, oh, this should be so much better. This should be, that you could do this, you should do that. And I'm like, Overkill will never listen. I've told them this already, so they hopefully are already taking what I've said into account, you know? But maybe that's an example that they are. Maybe they are working on this shit in the background and I don't know. And you saying that is making me think, oh, cool, they're working on things. That's nice. Who knows, genuinely? Who actually knows? I don't. Who knows a Doctor Who podcast? Who's there a Doctor Who podcast? Whatever. Do you guys remember Overkill's The Walking Dead? I think most people would rather not at this point, unfortunately. Because it was an intriguing time. Let's say that. I always said I was going to stream that, and I never did. Should I stream that at some point? Sorry, no, I did. I did. I actually forgot. That says a lot that I forgot that. Jeez. That says a fucking lot that I forgot that. Because I streamed it with Grouse, didn't I? 2, 3, 4. What switching an engine mid-dev does to a motherfucker. I can't believe that. As Ezra just said a minute ago, like, a lot of it is down to Bo. We know this. Bo and his questionable fucking choices. Highly questionable choices. Remember Koch Media's presentation where we waited 3 hours for a picture we'd already seen? It was like, oh, Joshua!
How are you today?
I'm really good, man. Thank you for those bits. That means a lot to me. That means an absolute fucking ton, more than you know. Very, very happy. Thank you, King. But I'm good. And you know what? I haven't looked at the Twitch stats right now. I don't know how many people are watching. I feel a little bit uneasy not knowing that information because I'm so used to looking at it. But I'm also kind of glad that I'm not. And please, no one tell me how many people are watching right now because I know someone will go, oh, actually, it's this many people. Because I'm just... And this is what I like about Minecraft. Because I really like how chill the game makes me. And this is why I think it'd be a nice weekly game to play for the people who want to hang out. Because it's almost like just chatting, but with gameplay. You know, this is the most kind of just chatting game you can have. Which I think is really enjoyable. Lucky you said I was about to type it. This is the thing, Stu. And I've said it a few times now, and I don't want to keep saying it every stream. Because I know it's going to piss people off, because it makes me sad talking about it. But as I've said before, teaching placement, it's kind of dogged the Twitch down a little bit, you know? It's been dicked down hard. That's a phrase. Dicked down hard. Yeah, and recently playing new games and seeing the viewing figures not be good for them is constantly kind of putting me down doing content. So I don't even have Twitch open on Opera. I don't have a number on OBS right now. I've hid it. Basically, on my OBS, I have a button where I can switch between the start and stop streaming controls and seeing the Twitch stats. I've left it on the start stop controls, so I can't see the Twitch stats. Haven't got a clue. It means that I can't also see how many current subscribers there are, but I don't think that fucking matters to anybody. Because we can kind of just ascertain how many have subbed recently from the sub goal. That's as much as we need to really know at any one time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And hopefully just... the problem is I've got to get back to more consistent timing. And if my heart's not in it because I know not many people are watching anymore, it kind of impacts how often I want to stream. Like, I'm not going to pretend and say that hasn't had an impact on how often I've streamed recently, because it has. There have been a few times in the last couple of weeks where I've just thought, should I just, like, take a month off or something? Like, and just like, wait until I really do want to start streaming properly again and get the audience back. But the problem is now, we've been affected so much by the placements and people not really watching anymore that the only way I can get it back to the way it was by giving it the same push that I did when it started building to begin with. Do you know what I mean? So, one good thing has happened, though. Cold War is getting an update tomorrow. Ezra reckons the map was already added a few days ago, but I don't think that's the case, because the post is saying it's adding the map tomorrow, so I don't fucking know. Or the gun was, I don't know. But Cold War is getting its first new multiplayer map in ages, as well as a new weapon. And Treyarch said it's the first Cold War update of 2022, which suggests we're going to get some new Cold War content this year, which would be very... Oh, God, fucking food is coming back up on me. Which would be very, very, very good, because if we could bring back at least a few Cold War Mondays, that'd be great. The charity stream is probably going to be big, maybe a bit of a boost in general. I'm hoping so, and I know that people who've hooked me up with the company to do the charity stream, they've been like, you know, we see often charity streams get more views than the average stream. And I hope that's true, because that might actually help. That might genuinely help me boost viewers back. And then it's not just helping a good cause, but it actually ends up helping me a little bit in a way that I'd really like. And that'd be sweet. That'd be really nice. Actually, yeah. So, should we talk about the charity stream for a minute? Just for people who don't want to know a bit more details and some of the guests. Noli has been talking to me. He's also going to be taking part in the stream. We haven't decided to what capacity yet. But he's a new guest. Coming with a signed N7 cap from Troy. Did I say that was going to be a prize? Because I don't think I said that. But I will tell you that I have suggested that to the company who've hooked me up. I don't know how much I can share, but there's a company that basically, like, helped me with giveaway prizes and stuff, and they can decide, you know, they can help me give certain things to give away to people. They give me a budget and kind of offer to help cover some stuff, and they've said that if I can, I can, like, have personalized gifts for giveaways, and I actually genuinely like one of the gifts to be a signed N7 cap. I would genuinely like that to be a gift, and I have asked them, they haven't come back to me yet, but I'm hoping that might be a good thing, because the cap's quite cheap to buy. The main thing will be shipping it, so shipping it to me to sign it, and then shipping it to whoever wins, especially if they're in another country. If they're in the UK, it's piss easy, but if they're not, then it becomes more difficult, do you know what I mean? Plus, if I'm sending it off, I've got to make sure there's none of my personal details on it. I don't know how the Royal Mail works like that. I'll have to figure out how it all works and get it sorted, because I don't want to fucking dox myself sending off a giveaway prize, you know what I mean? But yeah, so basically the way it's going to work is on Saturday... at 7 PM UK time, so that's GMT, so feel free if you don't already know. Well, it's when this stream started, so 40 minutes ago from now on Saturday, so in 2 days' time. It's going to be a 3 or 4 hour stream. 3, 4, 5. It's going to be a 3 or 4 hour stream where we won't be playing Payday 2 the whole time, but it'll be very Payday themed because that helps get more people in. You know, there's a bigger Payday audience. But I'm going to have Ian Russell's going to be taking part. We're planning on doing like a little lock Q&A for about half an hour of the stream, hopefully. He's got his own special gift to give away. He literally messaged me when I said I was looking at doing the charity stream. Mariner Top Hat guest appearance. That would be cool. But I'm not sure. I think he's busy on a Saturday. He's normally streaming around that time. I'll just finish. So I don't imagine he would want to slide in. I should have asked him. But I can almost kind of assume he probably wouldn't. Probably shouldn't assume. But he's not really as much of a co-stream guy. Because I have asked him in the past if he fancied it. And he's kind of like, you know, he's not as sure. I'd love to do a co-stream with him at some point, though. I really would. Because I love the dude. He's a good friend. And nothing I'm saying is like saying I don't think he'd help me or something. Because he's literally a mate of mine. So I it's not like it's malicious. I just don't think he'd be up for it personally. But yeah, he has a one-of-a-kind lock-themed gift that he said he'll sign on stream and send out to the highest bidder in a certain time. Because the way the giveaway works, there'll be two giveaways for the sounds of it. One will be Locke's prize and one will be the prize that I get done with this company. The way it works with the company one is there's like a period of, I think, 10 minutes where anyone who donates during those 10 minutes will get an entry in the giveaway. So you can donate before then, and I would love if people did, but you'll only be entered in the giveaway if you donate during that set time. And then at the end of that set period of time, whoever is picked out at random wins said prize. With Ian's, we're thinking about working it slightly differently. We're thinking of during, while we're doing the Q&A with him, whoever donates the most money while he's on the call, maybe, will get the prize. And we might include people who donate before that, so it's not unfair. Because if we're doing, you know, who's donated the most and someone's donated before the interview, it might be a bit unfair not to count that. Do you know what I mean? So that's kind of where our heads are at. But, you know, we're open to suggestions. The only other thing is, and I'm going to confirm these now with the company, hopefully tomorrow. I have asked them how many I need and they haven't come back to me yet. That's the only reason I haven't confirmed it yet. But we need donation milestone ideas. So when you donate a certain amount, you get you get X gift. You know, you get X thing happening on stream. I do X activity. I stream X game in the future. Whatever it might be, you know? So there is a Discord channel. If you haven't seen it by this point, then you're probably living under a rock. Like this mine is right now. Ha 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 ha. Relevant puns. But if you haven't got any, if you got any ideas for A, giveaway prizes, because there's still a little bit of a chance to get your input there, or B, any milestone goals for donations, leave them in the Charity Stream Ideas channel. It's pretty much your last chance to do that now. But there are some really good ideas in there. They've had a look through. I've had a look through. There are some good things in there, so I'll definitely be incorporating at least a couple. You know? Troy tries to solo stealth less or 100 donations. We could, do you know what we could do? We could do like a solo stealth lesso until I complete its stream. Which I don't think, like, I might have to break it if I stream for like 3 or 4 hours and don't beat it. But we could do something like that. That could be a good milestone reward. No skills, no perks. Abso-fucking-lutely not. We want to at least, me to at least have like a 2% chance of doing it. Train heist at 200. We could do train heist, no skills, no perks. Like, that would still be very fucking difficult, but I'd rather do that, no skills, no perks, than a lesso. I feel like that... Or is that really stupid? That might be really stupid as well, to be fucking honest with you. But we could set it to a lower difficulty, like overkill. Deathwish might make it... Mayhem Plus might make it irritating, do you know what I mean? I don't know. Or I could at least try it on Death Sentence, and if it takes too long, we could knock it down to overkill. I'd knock it down to Deathwish or Mayhem, but as most of you know who do stealth, the stealth mechanics are the same from Mayhem and above. So if you wanted an actual difference, you'd have to take it down to overkill. Train heist, no skills is a nightmare. I feel like you're saying that from experience, which says a lot to me. It says a lot. But yeah, so... Oh, for fuck's sake, it's going off the screen again because it says featuring Tyler, the creator. Oh, well, you know what? Fucking suck it up. Probably should move it, shouldn't I? I probably should move it. Well, who cares? Anyone care enough? Or shall I just leave the snip as it is? But yeah, so any last ideas, go drop them in the Discord channel. But that'll be 7 o'clock UK time, Saturday night, and it'll be 3 to 4 hours long. In fairness, I will be fair. The company did say the streams were meant to be 5 hours. But I said to them, I went, I'll be honest with you. It's very, very rare I've done a stream that long. The only streams I can think of off the top of my head that were that long were the Mass Effect Legendary Edition stream last year and the Doki Doki Literature Club stream on YouTube. Am I right in thinking we've never had a stream 5 hours or longer beyond those two? Because I don't think we have. And I was fucking knackered after those. Mass Effect, it wasn't as bad because I spent half the time crying at certain points, so I wasn't really talking. Doki Doki, my throat was dead. Was gone. So I never wanted to replicate that. Anyone who was there for that YouTube stream knows my throat was demolished at the end of that. One of the Minecraft streams, you know, the PC said, oh yeah, that was like 6 hours when it was like Payday 2 to Minecraft. How did I even do that? I genuinely look back now thinking, how the fuck did I have the energy to do that? Because I don't know. GTA Definitive Edition update. Spoilers, it's still bad. Yeah, honestly. Didn't I say I was going to do Vice City Definitive? Could do that. I've dropped the... What have you dropped? What have you dropped, Chris? I've dropped the best stream idea. Take a look. Let's have a quick peek. What have you said? I should be a guest star on the charity stream, bro. Someone donate 100 and make Troy join my lobbies. Joining Ellis's lobbies might be the most fucking painful thing in existence. We could make that a stream target, I suppose, though. Because I did say you'd have to pay me a lot of money to make me go in one of his lobbies. I suppose I could swap it for, you know, donate to charity a lot of money. I just realised, I've been talking about stream, I haven't said the company. So the charity that the money is going to is called Games for Love. I think I mentioned this possibly once before, I'm not sure. But they are basically a charity that hook kids in hospitals up with video games. Which I think is just really nice. It's nice and relevant for our channel. It's a good cause, because unfortunately, obviously, there are a lot of kids who spend their time in hospitals, and it is really unfortunate. There are a lot of young people who are in far less fortunate positions than we are, and I think it's nice to kind of provide them with entertainment like that. So, obviously, whatever money we can raise for that would be great. I've never done a charity stream before, so I don't know how much money we'll make during the stream. But as far as I'm concerned, any money we make will be going to the cause. That's what matters, you know? That's what matters most to me. Snips got stuck. Iconic. Just update the bot. Hang on. There we go. But yeah, so I think it'd be a really good cause. Katie Bentz has streamed for them before. Because I was looking and I was kind of going, right, what does the company do? Has anyone I know streamed about them before? And Katie has streamed raising money for them before. So I thought that was quite sweet. So there's someone I know has raised money for them. And it just seems like a really good cause, genuinely. I think it'd be really nice. And if it goes well, I would very much like to do more charity streams going forward. Because the company that have hooked me up with this whole thing have been really, really helpful. And I'd quite like to keep that communication open and do more in the future. Maybe we could do like a monthly charity stream or something. I don't know. It would be quite cool. Or every 2 months, every 4 weeks. We could set some kind of thing where we could do charity streams. I don't know. You know, but it would be nice. It would be nice. So it's very much a pilot test on Saturday to see how it goes. And if it goes well, we'll do more. So, guests, I don't want to tease everybody because I want to make sure that everyone can do it. But I kind of, shall I say who's going to be on it? Shall I tease the guests? I'm pretty sure everyone I've arranged with has confirmed they will be able to take part. So do I just say it all? Do I just say all the guests? What do we think? What do we think? What do we think? Every other hour, kill ourselves for charity. Every other hour, do a charity stream? Wow. Oh, you mean during Payday 2? Oh, right, got you. Speedrun the Payday 2 career mode? We could do. I feel like that would get a bit dull. Because it's just playing heists in order. That career mode, as we know, is more designed for people who are new to the game. And even then, it doesn't really give you much in the right way of rewards for it. But that's because Payday 2's reward system is very antiquated now. You know, this is a 2013 game reward system. You know, oh, you got a new color for your masks. Oh, you got a new mask. Wow, cool. That's the thing we've said about Payday 2. Now, Payday 2 really is showing its age. It's an old-ass game. And there's only so many more updates you can get before people are going to really start being like, you know, all right, let's have Payday 3. There are definitely people who are already like that now. I'm like that now. I don't think anyone is shocked to hear that I'm kind of like, you know, just give us Payday 3. I like Payday 2's updates, a lot of them still. Like, don't get me wrong. I think they're starting some very cool shit. But it's a game that I only play now for the updates. So I kind of stream it and go, oh, this is cool. This is a nice, cool content. But I don't tend to play it casually myself. Part of that is down to the fact that it's not on console. If it was on console, I probably would play it more casually. That is a fact. Like, I would probably stream it more. I'd probably play it more myself. But I just don't play on PC very much. So it all being on PC just kind of has me like, you know. And I'm already like, what infamy am I on PC now? Some kind of ridiculous amount, like 34 or something. I don't know. Which for me, add on 25 for Xbox One, plus like the 10 I'm on an Xbox now or something. I've got Infamous overall like 60, 70 times at this point. So there comes a point where you're kind of like, you know what? There's only so much more I want to do. And I think that's partially why I'm doing less Payday content, like less frequently as much as I used to. Although I did upload that little meme video like a week or so ago that got like about 3,000 views. That was quite cool. Re-uploading that from the dead, also Red Archer Live channel. Because that used to be my second channel, which was purely for just shit posts. But I just kind of decided it's not up to upload on there anymore because now the Cosmic Vortex is kind of like my second channel. Like, that one actually deserves to be a second channel rather than just like a shitposty one. And I've got enough YouTube channels right now that I don't upload on. I don't want to start adding to that fucking pile anymore. So the Redcast Clips is already dead and also Red Archer Live is dead. I've got the main channel. I've got the Twitch archive. I've got Cosmic Vortex. And now I've got the Who's There podcast. There's only so much you can do, you know? So, I might take a couple of other meme videos off of that channel and re-upload them, but I think a lot the other ones are kind of more, like, based on dead memes, like Coffin Dance and stuff, so it wouldn't really make sense to re-upload those. The one that I uploaded that told me something I don't know was like, just, like, kind of a meme generally. It wasn't based on, like, a trend, so it made sense to re-upload that one. But, I don't know. I do that shit for free, my man. You okay, Chris? You okay? We're here if you need us, buddy. You got a single continental coin. What do you mean? Shit. Oh, we got no pickaxes left. Isn't that nice? Right when we found some iron. Well, we can get a thingy. We can make some iron pickaxes now. I don't know whether you can mine iron with wood. I don't think you can. You think I should know this by now after playing Minecraft for, what, 10 years? Iron. No, I alien. Shut the fuck up, alien. Shut up. Stop talking. I should build a base of some kind. I don't know why I'm just like digging into a hole in the wall and not doing anything else. I said that when we were discussing the Payday 2 progression. Ah, right. Okay. Gotcha. What, you get like one continental coin, what, for beating career mode? Feels like it, honestly. What rewards does it actually even give you? I genuinely don't even remember. Gives you like some cash, does it? And like weapon attachments or something? I don't know. It's just stupid. It very much is designed with new players in mind, which isn't a bad thing, but it's not really something that new players can really enjoy that much. You know what I mean? At least I don't think so. But hey, that's just me. Money, attachments, and coins. Well, it's not really that good, is it? Realistically. Actually, really, for stacks, I should put more coal in than that. No, fuck it. Who cares? Right, let's just get enough for two iron pickaxes, and then we'll go down again and see what we can find. If you want that, just play Crime Spree. That is true. I remember Crime Spree used to be such a cool idea, and now I don't play it at all. Like, I genuinely cannot remember the last time I loaded up Crime Spree. And it was a cool idea at the time, and I did like it. It took so fucking long to come out on console, though. Holy fucking shit, that took forever! Story mode eventually gets to a point where you get where all you get is continental coins. Yeah, it's... Well, there you go, then. And I still find funny that Goris, bless his soul, whatever happened to him, I don't know. But I remember him saying, oh, we've added story mode to console. And like, they were like, oh, it stopped after, like, before even Brooklyn Bank. There were some heists that were added to console that didn't even have story missions. And he was like, that's all there is to story mode. There is nothing else to story mode. And it's like, well, that's not fucking true. There are heists you've added to console that don't even have their associated story missions in there. There was something, like, I can't remember the stats. I remember reading out in a YouTube video, but there was something like 70 or 80 story missions. They'd added about 48, and you could do like 60 in console, like before you came to content that wasn't added. And those ones they hadn't even added. They just went, ah, we're just going to end it randomly after like a Crime Spree task or something. It was fucking stupid. It was so stupid. Crime Spree on charity stream then? That would be cool. But yeah, so I don't know how many guests I can talk about. Like I've said, there's going to be Ian Russell. Noli's going to make some kind of appearance. We haven't decided how much, how long, or in what capacity yet, but he said he wants to be a part of it, and I'm more than happy to have him be a part of it. Well, I asked him to begin with, but he said he was up for it. But I'm going to be playing Payday 2 with... Can I say... I don't want to say it and then find out it's not happening, because that would then be unfair. I don't know. I'll be playing Payday with another guest. I'll have a brief call with another guest. It will vary. There'll be some cool stuff. So maybe we could put some Crime Spree in there. That could be interesting. That could be very interesting. Who knows? I'm not against the idea. Okay. Right, is all the iron smelted now? Yes, it has. Right, so. Noli joins voice chat, plays the new Payday 2 challenge at 20 times speed and leaves. Can you beat Payday 2 as a charity streamer? That's going to be his next video. At what point do you plan to reveal my cameo on the stream with my hour-long essay, The Entire Biology of a Sheep? Now you're just bullying yourself at this point. You're riding into the meme, Elian. Do you want us to call you a sheep shagger for all of eternity? Have you just embraced that now? Like, what's happening? Have you embraced it the way you embrace sheep every night? See what I mean? Do you want lots of those jokes, Elian? Do you want them to continue forever? If you embraced eternity. There are a couple of songs in this album that are very bizarre. This one is very strange. It's like just Abel talking and all of a sudden it goes into a radio ad. Which obviously makes sense because it's meant to be like a radio station, this album, but still. Every angel is terrified. At some point, you should accept who you are. And for Elian, that is a sheep shagger. Fair enough. See, it just starts like a radio ad. edgy. Wow, what is this, an advert for Shadow the Hedgehog? Jeez. How are you doing? Hello, family unfriendly. Interesting name. I'm good, how are you? Welcome, welcome. How about my hour long essay of being alone? Bro, you make one too many of those jokes. It's starting to worry me now. Whoa, okay, the frames when that noise triggered. Sheesh, that's concerning. Okay. Great to hear. Good, good. Thanks, dude. Welcome to the stream. Hope you enjoy your stay. And if you do enjoy, feel free to drop a follow. I'd really appreciate it. Whoop. Oh, shit. Whoop. There we go. I could do with, I think, a few more torches. Big cave just loaded. Well, that's promising. Let's hope that we come across it in a second. That would be very nice. We may well need a shovel. I don't know. Let's see. Also need to put some stairs on this mine path at some point soon. Like, we all have our ways of getting down into these mines, and this is like always the thing I do. I always do a 2x2 shaft like this, and then but the height varies for some reason. I can never quite agree on the same height each time. Sometimes it'll be dead high, sometimes it'll be dead short. You know, it varies. It varies. Your creativity must vary, folks. Already following your content for a while. I'm very sorry then. Do you know what? I've said this a lot. I have soup brain and I forget usernames sometimes. But it did say that you were a first time chatter. That's what caught me. Said it was a first time chat from you. So that's all it is. That's probably all it is that's made me think that you were new. So my apologies. I appreciate you hanging out. Troy generally just loves shafting. Oh yeah, love it. Love them big shafts. Yeah, let's just go for it. Let's just go for it. Yeah, great. Go on. Let's make loads of the sex puns. Go on, Alien. Go on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I need some more torches now. Isn't there, like, I swear I remember hearing there was a new spawn point for diamonds. Was it someone told me on stream? Or did I just read it up somewhere that's, like, minus 40 and below or something is, like, now the new sweet spot for diamonds? Did I hear that somewhere? Like, they can spawn between below, like, level 20 or something, but the sweet spot is, like, really deep underground. Could somebody look that up for me, please, on Bedrock? Anybody who's got Google handy? Best diamond locations on Bedrock. Just because that's where I normally tend to stop and base. Like, wherever my mine is. So it'd be good to know kind of what I'm aiming for if anyone has an idea. I think what I'll do quick is build some cobble. Buy some steps. I'm going to buy some. Let's build some cobblestone stairs. And this time I know for sure, just don't break my heart. It's really funny when you listen to songs like this, right? And you kind of think, oh, you can understand what he's trying to say in the song. And then you watch a video, like one of the ones on YouTube. It's literally just called Breaking Down Dawn FM. And I don't know whether people have seen this channel. I can't remember the channel's name, but he basically, like, takes all the songs, listens to the lyrics, and compares them to, like, other albums and stuff, and tries to explain the story. And the video was really interesting because it kind of compared what he was saying in these songs to, like, older ones and saying how, like, Abel had changed as a person, like, the storytelling behind the album. And that, like, genuinely fascinated me. And you kind of listen, there actually is, like, a progression here where it's, like, don't break my heart, like, he thinks he's found a new love and thinks that they're perfect for him. And then the next song is I Heard You're Married, and, like, in the lyrics, like, I knew it was too good to be true. Like, I knew you'd break my heart kind of thing. And you listen, you're like, holy shit. Like, damn. Google says just go as low as you can. Cool. Between 15 and minus 63. Oh, good, that's a really small, concise range. I know roughly where to aim for. Between 15 and minus 63, bro. Okay, fair enough. We'll just keep going until we get quite low, and if I don't see a cave, I'll just start digging around and hope that I come across one. Because, I mean, one just loaded in, as we know. But the simulation distance is 10 chunks, so it could be far away. I don't know for sure.
How ironic. Kingo, the movie star.
I've directed some things, too. Some internet content.
How many views?
I don't do it for the views.
Insert joke here.
I wish that was true, but we need more views at this point. Dom using the first alert for 17 months, resubbing at tier 3. You sexy bastard. Thank you very much, King. How are you doing? How is life? Thank you for contributing to the sub goal, as you always do, you sexy bitch. I appreciate it. Oh, how's life, man? How are you in Sonata? Hope you're doing well. Between layers minus 50 and minus 64. Is that like a sweet spot for it? Okay. So we'll start heading towards like minus 50 then in that case. See if we can get down there. I didn't make torches. It was the one thing I said I was going to do. Well done, Troy, you fucking moron. Let's get all the way back up. See, now if we were on anything other than peaceful, this would burn away my hunger. Going up a staircase like this would demolish it. That's why I like playing on peaceful, bro. Right, okay. Make another iron pickaxe. We'll keep a couple for shovels, maybe. Almost a year and a half, but good. How goes the mining? Yeah, we're almost... You're almost a year and a half. Holy shit. That's crazy. I can't believe how long it's been since you started supporting me. And of genuinely being the biggest reason that Twitch is even slightly financially viable for me. You don't... I've literally said this to Dom. I've messaged him privately before. I'm sure he doesn't mind me saying... Literally saying that, like, he's half the reason that Twitch is even semi-viable for money for me. Because the amount of subs that man has gifted... I can't tell you that the smile it puts on my face every time is... He's just a fucking sexy bastard. And that's why I'm glad that he's got himself like a good job and he's got a girlfriend and everything, because he deserves to be happy with how nice he is to just this community. He's just a fucking lovely bastard. Run now before someone mentions the charity stream on Saturday. Oh boy, charity. Oh God. Yeah, I'm expecting... Yeah, there's going to be a giveaway running during the... like a Q&A with Locke. I'm kind of deciding that so whoever donates the most during the chat with him will get the giveaway prize. And people were already joking saying, oh, Dominic will get that prize then. So I find that quite entertaining, when people were saying that. Torches, I do not need such things for. I have very fucking high brightness. What, you just turn your brightness to max so you don't need torches? That's not very immersive, bro. What the fuck? Where's your immersion? Where's your immersion? Dom sniping both giveaways. No, the other one's random. It's just anyone who donates during that time. But for Ian, we were thinking about the person who donates the most. That's kind of what we're thinking to drive some initial interest. Because I think the lock giveaway will be first, and then the other like proper like official one from the company will be later in the stream. We haven't decided specifics of when yet, but. What I need to do realistically is come up with a schedule for the stream so people know what's happening when. The only way to nerf Dom 2-0, please nerf. Well, please don't nerf in the way of gifting subs. Not to sound greedy, but it's appreciated, and let's not nerf that, okay? Let's not nerf that. Oh, God. Oh, God, it's the Lil Wayne feature. It's the Lil Wayne feature! God, run! 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 It's fucking... It's just... I hate that lyric. You like it dirty, and I'm Dirty Harry. Oh, fuck off. Fuck off. What does that even mean? What does that mean? Fucking just, oh. That's the thing. That's what was so good about After Hours. Weekend didn't have a single feature on that album, and it was so good. Patch notes 3.3.22. Dom now uses Monopoly money. Ayo, what? What the fuck? Why is there clay here? Why is clay spawning at level 6? Do you have auto jump on? I don't think so. Why the fuck is clay spawning at this level? Right, it's there that we need the next torch. I'm old. Wow. Are you how old are you, Dom? I think you've told me before, but I forget. How old is the Demorbs? Oh, I can be with you. Dom equals boomer. I don't remember how old he is. But you know what they say, never ask a man his age, a woman her salary, whatever that meme is. 26, but just made an American Idol reference. Oh, fair. You're not that much older than me then. Fair. So you're telling me that in 4 years' time, I'll have a really good job and a girlfriend who loves me? That'd be great. That'd be great. I'd really love that. Thanks. That makes me feel better. Fucking hell. Like fun fact, I reinstalled and like reset up Tinder again a few days ago. And very quickly, within about like, I don't know, 5 or 10 minutes, quickly realized why I stopped using it. It's just full of, like, at least, I don't know about where everyone else, if anyone else uses Tinder, but it's just full of, I feel like, fake people. A lot of people are just like going out on nights out and just aren't really, they're not like, don't get me wrong, people who go on nights out are not necessarily fake. I know I've just said those two things back to back. They're not correlated. But there's just a certain type of person that uses Tinder that just is not my type at all. And that type pretty much just takes over the entirety of Tinder. The kind of people I like, the people who just, you know, don't like massive nights out, will prefer like nights in or going out to watch a film or get food rather than going out and fucking pissing their money up against the wall. It's not my kind of thing, you know? It just isn't. But most people that are on Tinder are that kind of person. And then if I match with anyone who's not like that, I don't tend to get replies, or they tend to unmatch right after. Tinder's just a bit shit, honestly. And I have genuinely looked. There are like Liverpool sometimes has like singles events, and I have considered going to them in the past, but I'm at that point in my life, and I've said this already, where I'm not like, I would like to meet someone, but I'm not like crying desperate over it. I don't care that much. Would I like to have someone in my life? Yeah, I would fucking love it. I think at this point now in time, I'm more interested than I was a few months ago, because now I'm not in teaching placement anymore. I'd have the time for a relationship. Because not my last one, but my one before. My relationship before last was completely destroyed by the fact that I had no time for it because of teaching placement. That was one of the reasons we broke up, was just that I never had time to see her because I was always teaching and planning lessons and stuff. Which is, you know, it's shit. So. Correlation, not causation. Possibly. What are these fucking robo noises? 3, 4, 5. Also, this song. Wow. Love it. I love this fucking song. Less than zero is such a tune. I moved 500 miles so I could be emotionally fulfilled, so I gotta take what life can offer. You gotta do what you gotta do, bro. You gotta do what you gotta do, you know? No taxation without representation. That's a fucking Fallout 4 reference, isn't it? No taxation without representation. That's in the Museum of Freedom. I know that because I played Fallout 4 recently. Actually, fun fact. I don't know whether I mentioned this, but I said I started a new Fallout 4 playthrough a couple weeks ago. Full with mods, like loads of clone armor and lightsabers and shit. I didn't realize how cool one of the lightsaber mods in Fallout was, because if you literally block, it sends bullets back at people and has like a ricochet effect, which is like a perk or something, and it genuinely does like do really high damage. When I first did it by accident, thinking, oh, imagine if you could block and it would send the bullet back, and it sent a bullet back and killed someone, I was like, what the fuck? But I've put in so much stuff. I've got one of my mods is like, you know, unlimited settlement building. Which, of course, is my own mistake for installing that, because obviously I knew it would melt the game, but I've put so much stuff down in my base now that whenever I try and fast travel there or just go there, the game auto crashes. So, I've kind of fucked myself there. I think it's the amount of lights I've put down. It's just a lot of lights. Which makes me sad, because I was really enjoying that playthrough and wants to actually keep playing through it. I want to keep playing the playthrough, you know, but mods were like, ha 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 ha. It's my own fault, you know. I've become more powerful, but at what cost? Anakin Skywalker moment. I saw the Twitter screenshot, you nerd. Which one? Oh yeah, I took a picture with it. Yeah, because like I had like multiple followers and they each had a lightsaber. And I gave them clone armor with a color that matched their lightsaber. I was proper like dedicated about for it. You can get mods for Fallout content. Did you not know this? It's literally in the main menu. It's been there for about 5 years now. They added mods to Fallout 4 fucking years ago. It's only Bethesda-approved ones, like, not Nexus ones. But often some of the ones that are on Nexus are on the Bethesda thing. Like, there is a bit of a... sometimes an overlap, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, there's some class ones. The annoying thing is you can do it on Skyrim, but Skyrim has 5GB mod capacity. But Fallout 4 only has 2GB capacity. I never understood why. It never made any sense to me. And I really do wish that they'd gone back retroactively and fixed that and made it 5GB on Fallout 4. But they never did, unfortunately. I'm on PC and use Nexus. Well, that's better. If you can play it on PC and use Nexus mods, that's obviously a much better option. So that's perfectly valid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Suddenly want to play Minecraft. Someone stop me before I go back to those days. Do it! We always have a special connection with Minecraft, Dom. Wasn't that the first stream where you gifted, like... was it 100 subs? It was 100 subs in that one stream, wasn't it? I remember it was like the first stream of that last, of the first, like the last Minecraft series. It was the first stream of that. I would hollow out the earth and yes. Yeah, like that. I still can't believe you gifted that many that day. Fucking hell. It was like, I kind of expected streamers just be like, nope, just break on me. But it was cool. Oh, and then Dom comes back again for the first stream of the new Minecraft series. Is Minecraft just what will always gravitate you here, Dom? Will you always be here for every Minecraft stream? It's a nice prospect. I like that idea. It was right when I moved out here, so I had money. Ah, gotcha. Well, I mean, you must have had fucking money to gift 100 subs. How much does that cost? A sub's fucking hell, that's $500. Sheesh. So that was like basically just giving me $250. That's ridiculous. Madness. I have a soft spot for the game. I'm a mad scientist for Redstone. Okay, so Dom's favorite game is Minecraft. So stream lots of Minecraft. So Dom hangs out in chat. Cool. I love how every joke I make like that makes it sound like I'm just desperate for him to show up and gift subs. And it's not. I like... it's why... that's what I find nice now. And I said this to you before, is that you know, back in the past, you used to just kind of, like, gift subs and slip out. Now, you, like, if you hang out, you're, like, talking in the chat more, which I really like. It's cool. I'm back. Sorry, got some donuts. You got donuts? What donuts? I want some. Gimme. Give donuts. By the way, Mum has literally said, we're going to see Batman in Liverpool on Saturday. And there's a Dunkin', a Krispy Kreme store. Like, there's a few in Liverpool, actually. My mum was like, right, just so you're aware, we're going to get some donuts while we're out. And I was like, okay, valid. We will do that. So who knows? I might have a donut on stream at some point. I might bring one on stream with me for the charity stream. Who knows? I might well do that. Oh, I think Dawn FM has just ended. Let me see. It has. Dawn FM has ended. Great album. Oh, it's looping. Let's put on Give Me the Future. Let's have that album on. I like this album. Let's go. Let's mix it up a bit, you know. Right. I'm getting more off time now. We're training a fourth lab technician to actually exist. Hey, I'm glad to hear it. I'm very glad to hear it. Also, this is the album I mentioned in the Discord, but it has a song that starts with "We're Living 1984." So get ready for when we get to that song, because yes, I will turn up the volume and you'll be able to hear that. I'll make sure you can. Oh, by the way, chat, yeah, the charity stream is what I said that was giving me the idea of trying to do a new YouTube layout. So what I'm thinking of doing is, like, I think I've said this already, but changing my layout a little bit. So, for example, during the stream, the Elgato will look a bit more like this. Like, it'll be, like, it'll take up some of the stream screen, and then, like, I'll be here, and there'll be other bits, like the donation goal on the bottom and that kind of thing. Do you know what I mean? So I'm thinking about trying to do a new layout for that just generally. Because it means I can see the full screen. Because there's a lot of, you know, I play my games through OBS. So what you can't see, I can't see. So I can't see the top right of my Minecraft right now. So a new layout like that would actually benefit me. But I don't know how everyone else feels about that. What do we think? What do we actually think? Would that be an interesting new layout? I'd have a different background here. I'd make like a new background probably. Or use the stars or something. I don't know. But let me know what you think. I'd be interested to see what people think of that. When I'm not here, I'm just T-posing to assert dominance on my co-workers, as you should. Assert that dominance, King. Do it. Can this man stop being so fucking based? Dominic is just a very based person. You can't change that any less than you can change the fact that the Earth spins around the sun. You know, you, some things you just cannot change. With a different background, I think it should be great. Exactly, yeah. I don't know whether I'd have the stars, because obviously moving backgrounds can use more CPU, and it's when I'm running like Payday 2, that might be a challenge. But I might get, like, a new image. I'm actually just thinking of generally changing the look of the stream at some point in the future, like, a new look. Like, the stars are always going to be a part of the red cast. And I have to say, I have got my eyes on a guest at the minute that I'm going to get in contact with for the future of the show. Because I really, like, there's one person I really want to, I really want to... There's a couple. There's like I said, Elian knows one of them. Elian knows I've been trying to ask one guest for ages. Elian has, like, kind of de facto become my not PR manager, where I just tell him who I'm looking to bring on the podcast, just so I have someone to tell. He knows someone in particular I've been trying to get in contact with for a while and arrange, and we're hopefully almost there. But there's someone else I've realized I can get in contact with, and I'm like, you know what? It'd be very cool to interview this person too. I like interviewing people, man. I really like interviewing people, and I haven't done it for a few months, so I want to do more. But yeah. What's going on? Are you just playing solo? I am, Dom, yeah. Because the thing is, with the last series, when I made it multiplayer, I just kind of felt as though, you know, there were people who, you know, people who joined the multiplayer segment, but it wasn't a server. So then in the future, if you wanted to keep playing, you'd have to join when I was streaming. And then if I wanted to play in my own free time, I'd be doing it, you know, I'd be working around worlds. And then people might be wrecking each other's stuff. And I kind of thought, because if it's not a server, going multiplayer makes it just a bit more of a headache. And also keeping it solo for me personally just means it's a nice way to just go back and add something new to a world every week or so. But actually, if you've got any ideas, because you probably end up contributing to them. I was saying earlier to the stream that, you know, I was thinking about doing some kind of feature where, you know, if you gift a couple of subs, you can put an idea into what I do in the world, like something I build or something I change about the world. And again, anyone else who's got ideas for that, feel free to let me know. Because I want there to be some kind of way that the community can still interact with the stream, even if though it's going to keep solo. So if you've got any ideas, let me know. Build a rat, please, thanks. Well, I might build a rat, but you got to gift some subs, you know? You got to gift some subs. But not yet, anyway. Like I said, we got to get set up first. Like, my goal is before we finish the stream to find some diamonds, but I do have to finish at a specific point because I've got a very important business call as a Twitch streamer at about 9:30 UK time. So I need to finish before then. So I need to finish in about an hour's time. So I'm hoping that we find diamonds before then. We went to Extreme Deal trying to figure out when they'd be available. One time in particular was really fun. Yeah, we went proper Sherlock Holmes. I was like, Elian, help me work this out, please. And like, he was just like proper doing like calculations of dates and shit with me. It was so funny. So once it finally happens, I'll be buzzing. Hopefully everyone else will be as buzzing as I am. But like I said, for the interviews in particular, I don't really give a shit whether lots of people watch it or not. Because it's my own personal thing. I keep thinking that for my career, I want to get into something like interviewing people like on radio or in TV or something. I'm going to try and look at some kind of opportunity there, I think. Because there's a thrill that interviewing people gives me that not much else does. I love getting to know people that I admire. People whose work I really like or people that I just think could tell interesting stories. And that's why, like, obviously I've done Payday people, but I've also tried to mix up beyond others. Like, the Agent 47 interview, David Bateson, is one of my faves. He's just a genuinely interesting man to talk to. And I really like keeping that up and talking to new people. But at the minute, you know, it's been... How many months since the Erica interview? I think David Bateson was September and Erica was December. So at the minute, it's like every 3 months is an interview. And that's a little too infrequent for me. I want to make it a bit more frequent, you know? But I need to have more guests to talk to. And that's why I said at the time I was glad that I stopped doing every 2 weeks for the Redcast. Because it gives me more time to kind of plan out who I want to talk to, get in contact with them, not have to rush them and be like, can you work to this date or something? I could just kind of be way more chill and be like, you know what? Whenever works for you, works for me. Let's make it happen, you know? And then we were entirely wrong anyway, so that was great. Yeah, we were trying to work out a certain time when one guest would be free. And we worked it out. It turned out we were completely wrong. So that was funny. But they messaged me on Instagram, and my Instagram turned off their notifications for some reason, so I didn't see the message for like 5 days. I don't know how good they are at replying to DMs, but I've replied now a couple of days ago, and they haven't come back, so I'm like, oh, shit. But as Darth Maul once said, I have waited so long, I can wait a little longer. I'm about to build the entire MC world. Imagine, yeah, I just say something like, oh, you know, gifting 2 subs means you can influence 1 creation in the world, and Dom just gives like 50 and goes, all right, build this. He just gives me like a fucking Tesco shopping list. I worry now that he'll have cogs turning in his head thinking, this is a massive shaft, which sounds really weird out of context, but this is like 100 deep. Like, we were like at 70 up there, now a minus 36. Like, holy shit. Fine, I'll do it myself. You're scaring me, Dom. You're scaring me, bro. You're scaring me. Oh, yeah, I was going to get a shovel, wasn't I? Let's make a shovel. No more bad days. Mm-hmm. 100 deep, that's what she said. When has she ever said that's 100 deep? I would like to know. Oh, it's much more than 100 deep. We're at 80 up here. Fucking hell. Right. We got any iron ore to cut? Seemingly not. I got into using hoppers and chests to automate furnaces, and I can't stop now. That's quite cool. I probably should do something like that, but I haven't. There'll be no bad days. There'll be no bad days. You'll have no more bad days. Do I not have any iron left? Oh, shit. Did I just build a bunch of pickaxes? Oh, fuck. I'm almost out of iron. Shit, bro. That's not good. We need more iron. Isn't there like a certain altitude that normally spawns at, though? I might have gone too far down. Wait, rails? Do you know what? When I was talking earlier, I thought I hit a button by accident, and I did worry, but I didn't notice, so I just went, fuck it. We're fine. Obviously, I didn't do what I thought. I must have built a fucking stack of rails with the leftover iron. Oh, why? Freaking hell. Now I'm genuinely annoyed. Fuck's sake. Hang on, are we about to get the, is it Back to the Future next? It is, here we go. Alright, get ready. Who's ready? He's ready for the 1984 lyric. Ready? You ready? I'm just gonna turn it up a little bit just for this bit. Feels like we danced into a nightmare. We're living 1984. There you go. There's your 1984. You got it. I hope David's still here. Is David still here? Is David still here? If he's not, then he's just let down the entire RHEL community. He is 1984, man. We live in a RHEL court. Fuck's sake. It's just like George Orwell's book, 1984. It is. It honestly is. Do you know what you guys should do? You should subscribe 1,984 times to Red Arch Live on Twitch. Just kidding, unless. Average day on the RHEL cord. I love how that became a meme just because I was like, hey, don't be too horny in chat. It's just a basic human request, guys. Don't be too horny. Okay? Don't be too horny. Alright. No. Alright, E-Data. Fucking hell. I don't know how much we're going to cut. Oh, this is going to be so long with a stone pickaxe. I want to keep the iron one in case we find decent resources. In the middle of the night, I can dream away. Change what I like and go back to the future again. What's the lightsaber mod name? I can't remember because there are a couple of them. There are a couple of them. And I can't tell you reliably without looking on Fallout 4. I might be... No, not... The unique Magicka Savers is a Skyrim one, so I don't actually know. If you want to automate your furnaces, just let me know and I can teach you. That would be very cool. Make sure you swing by to the next Minecraft stream, because that's more likely going to be building shit like that. The goal right now is to get some resources, and I think next stream will be the building one. Which is pretty much, I think, how we did it last time when I did the last series, but it works. You know, get some basic resources, then think about building. Stone pick on deep slate sucks. Yeah, I'm feeling that. I'm feeling that feel. If there's any point you think I should just stop and start digging out and expanding, feel free to let me know. But I'm thinking we go down to like, what was it Alien said, between minus 50 and minus 64? Fucking the way the frames go when that audio starts, I swear down. Five. You need two hoppers, two chests, and a furnace. Okay. You need three paper clips, a can of soda, and a prosthetic leg. He said porn. He said porn. Guys, he said porn. Can you believe he said porn? I knew there was a lyric coming up and I was like, should I make a joke out of it? But I kind of left it a bit too late to increase the volume. Whatever. Guys, he said porn. Can you believe he just said porn on a Twitch stream? It's crazy. No, shit. I meant chloride. Do you have any of that lying around? No, for fuck's sake. Porn. Yes. He said virtual porn. Are we having fun yet? Are we having fun yet, chat? Are you guys having fun watching this stream? I hope so. And the new update, it's way more profitable to just cave dwell than mine. Yeah, it is. Once you're in a big cave, it's better to just explore that. But we, unfortunately, haven't found said cave yet. I bet you it's, like, right above us or something, and I just haven't seen. But it's hard to know, you know? What we could do is, like, branch off and create, like, a mine on a certain level and explore it, see if we can find it. I'm getting very close to just going back to the iron pickaxe and just cutting through some more deep slate for a bit. Because fucking hell, this is taking a while, innit? This is taking a fucking while, isn't it, lads? I feel like the brightness is much darker down here than it was before. Like, I'm noticing I have to put the torch every five blocks now, where it wasn't as often as that before. Just me. At least that's what I think. We've committed to sitting in the massive shaft for no reason. Well, no, we want to be in the massive shaft. The RHEL cord loves a massive shaft. Yes, I've just said that. I'm pretty sure I've just put a splinter in my tome. There's like a wooden like skirting board on my wall, and I've just glided my foot along it, and I'm pretty sure a teeny piece of wood just came off and splintered my tome. And I really hope it hasn't, because it's fucking hurting. I'm just trying to check. take my sock off. Feet reveal? Not happening. I can't feel anything. But it's sore, so I don't know. I'm skipping this because I don't like this on the album. It's fucking stupid. And this one's a tune. Right, okay. Right, what height should we stop at? Actual minus 64 or stop at like minus 60 or something? The wall in front of my desk is straight up drywall and I've put my foot through it so many times there's a massive hole underneath my desk. Well, that's not very clever, is it, Chris? It's a good job that, like, your wall's not, like, you know, like an exterior wall. Just put a hole in the house. Like, wow, it feels a bit cold in my room today, and then you realize your foot's just, like, outside. Just a bird sat on your foot. And you said, shut off the lights, we don't need them to dance. Minus 69. Very nice, Ant Dude, but we need to be between minus 50 and minus 64. So minus 69 would be too low down. I had to re-record 15 minutes of footage because I forgot your stream was on in the background. Rip. Wow. Wow. So, not only were you not moderating properly, you were trying to record footage at the same time. That's karma. That's karma. You ain't going to get any pity from me, Ezra. You ain't going to get any fucking pity from me. So, the one time when I went to record Payday 2 gameplay during a Zoom lecture, and then just realized my uni lecturer was talking in the background of the footage right the way through. So, that was funny. And I know what you're thinking. Troy, shouldn't you have been listening to that lecture? Probably, but he was talking shit, and I didn't care. Stay in school, kids. Can't have the Ral Minecraft commentary on my MGR, no damage. Well, you know what? Lol. When's the Mass Effect no damage coming? Oh, that's a joke. You'd have to play Mass Effect to do that. Everyone in the chat is so well-behaved. Can someone do a swear so I can suppress them? Yeah, you know, come on. Someone denounce, I don't know, cats. The film. That'd be easy to do. Did you upload it? Well, of course she's not uploaded it, Ant Dude. That's what she's saying. She had to re-record the footage because she realized that I was talking in the background. Because she's silly. She's a silly goose. Aren't you, Ezra? You're a silly goose. Right, we're almost at minus 60. Once we get to minus 60, I'm giving up the ghost. Because friggin' hell, it's taken us a while to get this far down in the mineshaft. I mean, blimey. Good grief, lads. What the fuck is going on here? Right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What are those black borders on the side of the screen? I think it's because we're so deep in the mine. I'm wondering, actually, yeah, it's like vignette, isn't it? It's fucking odd. I think it's because we're so deep in the mine, but I don't know for sure. I don't think I can turn those off. Is there anything in the settings where I can do that? Yeah, that's being below zero. Ah, there you go. And we are certainly below zero. Keep forgetting that's a lyric as well. Do you want to just listen to that lyric again, chat? Do you want to listen to this? Hang on. Wait. Ready? In an anxious age, Lord above, need to get me laid. This is just Ral called the album. We're living 1984. We've got Need to Get Me Laid. Like, damn. Bastille horny. Bastille horny. 1980 horny. Oh! At minus 60! At minus 60! Let's fucking go! Good shit. And we're literally at bedrock as well. Beautiful. 2, 3, 4, 5. Amazing. Alright. This is gonna be one diamond, isn't there? Ah! Oh, it's so fucking peak. There's only one diamond. But it's fine. We found one. It's not really fine. I wanted much more, but we move, okay? I don't think going dead this deep down is a good idea now, because I don't know whether we'll be able to find many other diamonds. Will we? I I mean, I kind of want people to dare me to make a diamond shovel and just dig around the gravel, but I don't think I'm brave enough to do that. Play Minecraft because I can make your bed rock. Wow, it's been a while since I've said that to somebody. Streamer, does that mean you said it to a girl before? I'll let you make your mind up on that one. Do you know the gravel mining trick? Is it the putting torch at the bottom of the gravel? Because yeah, but I'm just too lazy. Boom. Wait, what? You play Minecraft because you're a wooden home. What, wooden? Like she's got no personality? Damn, bro. Damn. You could be like, because I think you've got your eyes on this wooden hoe. I don't know. I don't know how you make it better. I'm just trying to make it a better pun, but I don't really think it worked. You got it. Also, be glad you missed my last message. Well, now I'm going to look up. Fun fact, platypus are nature's omelette factory, as they're the only mammal that produce milk and eggs. You can't unread that. Intriguing. Platypus omelettes. Delicious. I have no idea if they're delicious. They probably aren't, but I said that purely for the meme. Right, we're gonna cut off at minus 56. That seems like a good point to adapt. Let's split off the mine track here and go down this way. I stay awake. Why would I stay awake? Me when I want to go to bed. Why would I stay awake? Just thinking I build like a little side bit in the staircase here before building the slit off. That'll work better. Alright. Now I don't know how exactly to do this section of the mine. I don't really know how to split this up now. Now I'm on the other side. Hey streamer, when's the singing stream happening? Good question. I love how I said that would happen months and months and months ago and it never happened. Still fully intending to do a singing stream at some point, but I need to teach myself songs on the guitar / ukulele before I do that. I'm not going to just start singing a cappella, am I? Like, come on. I could sing along to songs, but I don't want to hurt everyone's ears, you know? Play Wonderwall. Never. You'd have to pay me a lot of money to make me do that. Troy not doing Pitch Perfect. They did 5 of those movies? Seriously? I thought they did 3. Are they any good? Who's actually seen the Pitch Perfect films? Or is that the joke, Ellen, that there isn't a Pitch Perfect 5 and I am Pitch Perfect 5? Is that what you're trying to say? I don't know. I haven't seen the film, so I don't know. Nice soundtrack for mining. Look who it is. Look who it fucking is. The pain in my ass. I'm sorry. How are you doing, Amelia? Good to see you, pal. Hope you're doing well. I counted wrong in my head. They did stop at 3. I was going to say, because already 3 seems like too many for those films, but I never saw them, so maybe they're good. I don't know. Maybe they're good films. Who knows? I enjoy the first 2. Oh, I've just realized. Have I got enough iron? I've got enough iron for another pickaxe. Okay, that's good. Ready to hear this one break? It's going to happen any second. Also, can't believe you're so late to the stream, Amelia. Like, what the fuck? An hour and a half into the stream and now you show up? What the frick? What the freaking frick? You trying to tell me that you've got other friends? We both know that's not true. Sorry, that's really mean. I like how the bot has also given up on the song again. This is not Stay Awake anymore. Actually, Amelia, resident Bastille fan, what do you think of Give Me the Future? Because I have mixed feelings about it. Because I like the songs on it, but I also don't like that A, half the songs were released before the album came out, but that's not a problem unique to this album with Bastille. That's why when Doomdays came out, I just didn't listen to those nights before the album released because I was really sick of hearing all the songs beforehand. So that's one problem. There's not many songs in the album. Half the songs are fucking interludes, like half a minute interludes. I also just don't like the Riz Ahmed thing at all. And I like Riz Ahmed. It just felt so unneeded. What do you think, Amelia? And anyone else who's heard this album, if there's any other Bastille fans out there, I don't know if there are. But if anyone else is out there who's heard the new Bastille album has thoughts to share, please share them. I would like to know what you think. Because I just... I don't know whether it... Least favorite might be pushing it. Because I do like this album quite a bit, but I just, there's parts of it I don't like, and I don't feel like I've had that problem before with the Bastille albums. I don't know. Speaking about new albums, though, Avril Lavigne's new album came out on Friday, and I haven't listened to it yet. I just saw that Anthony Fantano gave it a 4 out of 10, so yikes. But I don't know, I'm a pretty big Avril fan. Even though I've literally heard none of the singles off the new album, which is nice. It's refreshing to have not heard the songs ahead of time. I kind of like that prospect that now I can go into an album and be like, I've heard nothing here. Let's see what's new, you know? It's kind of like Dawn FM. I mean, all we'd heard was Take My Breath. It's great. Some of the songs have literal crack cocaine in them. It's an artistic masterpiece, but not always easy listening. Yeah, like Dawn FM, I have listened to over and over and over and over again. It's a fucking masterpiece of an album. And honestly, I enjoy it far more than Give Me the Future. But there are some great songs in this album. Back to the Future, Shut Out the Lights, Shut Off the Lights. They're fucking great tunes. But then again, like I said, half of them I've heard more than a year ago, some of them. And it's like, really? You know? I built a couple more stairs. Probably far more than I need. Just go and put these last stairs down while those ironing gets smelt. I mean, there's only literally four of them in the furnace, but it doesn't fucking matter. Also, fun fact about the new alert that Dom triggered earlier for 17 months. I realized when I was starting streaming today, I was like, oh shit, I've not done the alert for the end of last month. And then I went, oh no, you were behind on the last one and you made the one in advance for the next month as well, so you wouldn't have that issue happen. Because I knew I'd probably forget again. I'm so bad at remembering to do the alerts ahead of time. So I've got like all month now to do March's alert for 18 months. We need a good alert. I kind of want to do He Stole That Guy's Pizza, because I keep thinking that quote in my head, because I think because of Razzle, because I keep watching those videos. But Mario, I think, already has that as a stream alert. But then again, I don't think he'd give a shit if I use the same stream alert as him. I know that's an alert he's used. I don't know. Alright, so okay, there we go. I might just dig a little further into this, just to make it a bit easier to get off the steps in time. There we go. This is the thing now. I don't know what direction to go in. We only need just like more than one diamond, you know? I want to get enough for a pickaxe. I like how I said, oh, we're not ending the stream until I find diamonds, and I find a singular diamond. I should have been more specific. Maybe the game would have listened to me. Would have been nice. But you know what? We don't always get what we want, unfortunately. Oh, more iron. Well, that's something. Oh, and some gold. Damn. Imagine there was like diamonds right next to that as well. Be very nice. But life is not a fairy tale, unfortunately. Okay. Shit, I think I might need iron for that. Does gold need iron or does it need stone? I don't know. Someone clarify for me, please. Oh, fuck it. Let's just find out. It's taking too long. This needs iron. I think I'm almost completely sure this needs iron. Yep. Great. That's what I thought, so I don't know why I even tested that theory. I want satisfaction. Subscribe today, thank you. Second you find another diamond, you just sort of unceremoniously end the broadcast. Well, no. But I want enough for a pickaxe before we end, ideally. That's the goal. That's what I really want, you know? See, another interlude. Like, come on. Come on, bro. Really? Another interlude? Really? Right. Build a couple of pickaxes. Make a shovel. Done. I've just noticed someone replied to my YouTube post. It had a meme about Dream in it, and someone's replied saying Dream is the worst creature on Earth, I think, which is... Wow. Yeah, Dream is the worst creature to walk on land. What a comment. What a comment. That's intriguing. What do you think, chat? Do we really not like Dream? Do we not like Dream? I don't know. I actually have no idea whether people like Dream or dislike him. Some people like him, some people don't. I don't really know the reasons for and against. So... I need sticks. I agree with that guy. Fair enough, Chris. Fair enough. Sorry, I left. I was sorting something. Wow, imagine sorting things out. Imagine sorting your life out. I could never do that. Am I right, Amelia? She knows. She knows I could never do that. She knows I'm too much of a mess. What? God, that sounds really self-deprecating, and I didn't mean it to. It was only meant to be a joke. With the Bastille album, I don't know, the interludes and the Riz Ahmed tracks are individually gorgeous, but just mean it's not as easy to listen to. I just don't like the Riz Ahmed bit. I feel like it's one of the only Bastille things I don't like. It's just like, what the fuck is it? Why is he just randomly rapping? It just feels so out of place. You know? But I get, that's kind of how I feel with A Tale by Quincy on Dawn FM. You know? I love Dawn FM, but whenever A Tale by Quincy comes on, I tend to skip it now because I've already heard him talk about his mother being taken away in a straitjacket. Like, do I want to hear more? You know? The fuck is this? I wear a mask with a smile for hours at a time, stare at the ceiling while I hold back what's on my mind, and when they ask me how I'm doing, I say I'm doing just fine, and when they ask me how I'm doing, I say I'm just fine, but the fact is I never get off a mattress, and all they ask is, why are you so sad, kid? Why are you so sad, kid? What is that from? If I just read out lyrics from a cult chant? What's happening? You made a lot of progress until left. Well, we found a grand total of one diamond at the bottom at minus 60. Literally, as we, like, leveled out the mine, there was one diamond. The frames really are not happy at this level of the mine. Just sung Mask by Dream. Oh, God, really? Oh, can we, like, delete a section of a stream without knowing? Can we just, like, pretend that last, like, however many seconds didn't happen? I suck his dick with a smile for hours at a time. Really, Ezra? You like Dream? And you like him that much? Or are you trying to shitpost? Because that's an odd shitpost. Progress is progress, no matter how little. I like that. That's one phrase I like. I don't know whether Amelia's ever heard me say it, but I like the phrase, any progress is good progress. So, I like saying that at times. Nice little catchphrase. Stare at his nutsack while I hold back. What the fuck is that, Elian? It's the Sus remix. Oh, is it? There's a Sus remix of that. I'm glad I haven't heard many Sus remixes of things. You know? Oh, the Snipbot just gave up now. Why has Snip just gave up? Oh, it's just moved on to random Bastille songs. And apparently Snip just went, you know what? I'm good. Snip just went, you know what? I'm good. Fair enough. Right, what's in my recent albums? What else can we play? Is there another album I've played recently that we could add in? How do I look at my... How do you access your recent albums on the desktop app? Recently played. There we go. After Hours, Bit of Pale Waves might actually be quite nice. Yeah, fuck it, Bit of Pale Waves. I saw them live on Tuesday, they were very good. I had a great time. Thanks for asking, chat. Oh, I'm leaving the stream for that. Okay, good. Please don't leave, Amelia. I need friends. Why'd you have to live so far away, Amelia? It makes me sad. On a real level, not to get, like, emo, but, like, we're going to get emo for a second in the stream, you know, because, you know, Renato Live doesn't get emo very often, but, you know, he feels a bit emo the last couple of days. There's part of why my mood was so strange yesterday. When I was at the Pale Waves gig, they had a couple of support acts. One was called Bitters, and she was, I don't know whether it's she or just a band, but she was phenomenal, and I realized afterwards she only had, like, 2,000 monthly listens on Spotify, so she's, like, really up and coming. She only has 2 songs on Spotify, so go and check her out. I quite liked her. They had another support act, though, called Hot Milk, who were not quite my kind of bag. There were a few screamy songs, but they're, like, more popular, and they were also Manchester-based. I saw Pillows in Manchester, so, like, they had people who were, like, local, loyal to them. But at one point, one member of the band just went, the most important thing in life is hanging out at places like this with your best mates. And then there's just me, who, like, most of my closest best friends are either in other countries or on other sides of the UK. And I'm like, yeah, that's so true. That's so true. And I didn't really think about it properly until I got home that night. And when I thought about it, I was like, oh, that's emo. I feel quite sad now. I feel like, you know, I've picked friends who don't live very close. And it's sad. When you have that best friend living in another country moment. It's not epic. But what can you do? The pains of internet friendships. Exactly. And it's like, you know, wait, what? When you do it, it's fine. But when I date someone from another... You're dating them. I could never date someone who lived far away from me. Ever. I just could not do that. I need that physical intimacy. And that's half the thing. Like, and that sounds like I'm talking purely about, like, sexual stuff. I mean, just having that person close. Do you know what I mean? But I just like having, like, people, like, I can hang out with in person. And there are a few people who still live local to me, but they're often really busy with work and stuff now. It's life, you know? We grow up. We move on to other things. It's sad. Troy's sexual arc. No. It's not. We're not going to have a sexual arc. What, where I just talk about sex? Let's not do that. Let's not do that. Imagine dating someone. Hashtag cringe. Yeah, all right, Amelia. All right. All right. Just because you're like, oh, I don't date people. I don't date people. Well, that's not that you don't date people, but you know what I mean. Okay, great. More fucking gravel. No bitches. Yes, no bitches. But they're actually called women. I think you should be a bit more respectful, Fancy. Like, OMG. Shout out to Troy Sexual. It's one of my favorite sexualities. What does Troy Sexual mean? That you're only attracted to me? Or anyone with the name Troy? I'd love to meet a girl who was Troy Sexual. I'm just saying. That'd be really nice. That'd be really cool. Anyone know any Troy Sexuals? Fucking hell. I just straight up don't know anybody near me. I only talk to people from everywhere. That's fair. I'm Troy-phobic. Then why are you watching my stream? Don't leave. Don't leave, Chris, please. Cancelled. What do you mean cancelled? Good shout, I'll see you later. Wow. Damn. I can't believe that. Chris has left us. I'm really sad now. How dare you? Actually, Chris, you should listen to Who's There a Dog 2 podcast. I feel like you really like it. I noticed on Spotify that we didn't have any non-binary listeners, and I was like, can we get the non-binary community in on this? I want to get a more ranged, more diverse people of what you do. Oh, do you watch it on YouTube? Because I seem to remember this is what was confusing me. I seem to remember you saying you'd watch it, and I looked at the Spotify stats, and Spotify was like 0% non-binary. I was like, damn, we need to get the non-binary community in on this, man. You know, watch along. Yeah, I know the watch along will be back on Sunday. By the way, I never pinged to announce that. Whoops! I mean, no one fucking watches it anymore anyway, so it won't really matter, but I will. The watch-along is continuing on Sunday. So, don't have to change my gender at both IRL and on Spotify. Damn. Gender moment that I can't relate to. Unfortunately. Well, not unfortunately so much as just, I'm just a white dude, you know? I'm one of the boring people, you know? I'm just a white guy. Did you find Paul yet? No, we haven't found Paul yet, unfortunately. Just no longer starring the radio guy from Just Cause 3. Yeah, David Tennant was apparently in Just Cause 3, and I never knew. But I mean, I never played Just Cause 3, so. I'm often quite good at recognizing voices in games, though. So I feel like I would have recognized David Tennant's voice had I played that. But it's like I recognized him in a TV advert recently for like an online bank or something. I was like, that's David Tennant's voice. I just recognized it, you know? We must find Paul, guys, at all costs. We must. You must all listen to Who's There, a Doctor Who podcast. It's a great time. I'm gonna probably start editing episode 3 tonight after this call. So look forward to that on Saturday. That'll come out while I'm watching The Batman. Or maybe a bit before. I don't know. But we discussed the rumours about the 6th anniversary. That, you know, multiple Doctors will be returning. There might be specials for each one. And then I spend about 40 minutes talking about meeting Jodie Whittaker. And how crazy that was. So that it's a great time. What I find funny was Crispy was genuinely like, he really wants to know what happened in the Comic Con, and I made him wait until the recording so it'd be like a fresh reaction for him. So he literally was just enjoying hearing all the stories and asking me about shit for like 40 minutes. It was really fun. So I'm looking forward to editing it back and actually like hearing the stories and hearing his reactions again. Did you talk about Capaldi dipping? Yeah, we discussed that in episode 2, which you'll know about. And we mentioned it again in episode 3 that, you know, Capaldi coming back is highly unlikely. Which is, we'd love it to happen. So. I love this song. And that's what was so funny about this one. I posted it on Twitter. They did this song as like one of the last songs at the gig. And while Heather was singing it, someone like brought out a lesbian pride flag and handed it to her on the stage. Because Heather wrote this about her girlfriend. So someone handed her a lesbian pride flag. She just started waving it around while she was singing and wearing the flag. It was such a cool moment. It was really cool. And the way everyone was like cheering when she had it on. It was so cool. I loved it. I didn't finish episode 2 yet because Spotify uninstalled on my downloaded podcast. Well, that's not poggers. Also, I should point out, remember that on Spotify, if you listen to the podcast, there is a Q&A and a poll section that you can interact with. Only one person votes on the poll. I think it might have been Fancy, actually. But there is like a poll and a Q&A underneath where the playback bar on Spotify, so you can answer the poll and answer the Q&A. and you can get involved for the next episode of the podcast. It's cool, you know? That was you. Yeah, I thought it was you. You were the only person to answer that poll, Fancy. So, congratulations. How long do we have to keep going until we find diamonds? That is the question, chat. Number one, who's there, fan? What, you're Paul? You're Paul? You're our listener? Holy shit. The way that I want to, like, just belt out lyrics to this song right now. It's all I did at the Pale Waves gig. Like, every song they played, I was shouting lyrics the whole time. Which is why I'm surprised I still have a voice, to be honest. We recorded the podcast the next morning, and I messaged him before I went to bed and went, right, I'm going to be honest with you. There is a chance when we record this tomorrow morning, I'm going to have no voice. And he was like, oh, shit. And I was like, yeah, it could be a problem. And then, we've done about 14 blocks. That's the most likely level to find diamonds. It's between 50 and minus 64, I thought. Plus bedrock was about 60. Like, you'll see. We went down to minus 64 and there was bedrock. I'm finally recognized as non-binary by Spotify. Poggers! Unfortunately, the same cannot be said about my family. Oh, not poggers. That's not poggers. See, look, the bedrock just here. Minus 60. So, unfortunately not. But there we go. So now Spotify stats up, we'll say we've got one non-binary listener. Very nice. We'd love to see it. Let's have more, you know? If you're non-binary out there and you're not listening to the podcast, I mean, generally, it doesn't really matter about your gender, to be fair. Whoever you are, please listen to the podcast. I will say one thing. It's doing really well. You know, we've had a good few hundred views on both episodes on YouTube. We've got a decent amount of subscribers. The Spotify stats are quite cool. I'm honestly really happy with how many people are checking it out, and I just hope it continues, you know? I really am quite happy with how well it's kicked off. It's good fun. And it's not as hard to edit because it's only an hour episode apiece. That's really nice because, like, with the Redcast, because the episodes vary so much in length, it can really be a fucking nightmare to edit sometimes, especially if you're doing a lot of jump cuts. Depends on, like, what's happening in the interview. Because sometimes a guest will say something they don't want to share, or they get stuck in their words. You want to, you know, make it sound a bit more like, you know, they've got a straighter answer. Not because it makes them look bad, but because it makes it nicer to listen to when the reply is more clean cut. You might notice that sometimes in the edits. Often a lot of my edits are quite seamless. At least I think they are. Like, I managed to do a good job of kind of, like, hiding the jump cuts. It's one thing I pride myself in my editing. But there are a couple in Who's There recently I've been editing, and I've, like, cut out a certain bit to make it flow better and just gone, wow, that's a seamless edit. You would not know. Unless you're watching on YouTube, you see the cameras jump and obviously know then that it was a jump cut. But listening to it, you wouldn't know. And I love that. I'm gay and listen to podcasts. That says a lot about society. It really does. Oh! Ding dong! Ding dong! Ding dong! If it's just one diamond, I'm going to lose my shit. Oh, it's two. Good, good. Now give me more. Give me more. Okay, well, that's not right. Okay, so the maximum it can be now is six. Please be six. Fuck. Ah, it's just fucking two. Bruh. Well, we got enough for the pickaxe. That's what matters. Boom. Enough for the pickaxe de diamonds. De diamonds. Hello, pretty. Oh, God. Let's not go political, thank you. The veins are bigger now, so it might just be unconnected. Oh, really? So there could be more in that area? Okay, I'll bear that in mind. You change the lights up for me. You help me to believe. Right. Diamond, a pickaxe. Very nice. Right. Political, I was quoting the GOAT Stephen Dawson from Ashford, Kent. Who the fuck is that? Who the fuck is that guy? Who the fuck? I haven't actually heard of them. I don't know who that is. I genuinely don't. Don't look him up. You will regret it. You will regret it. Is that so? You don't want to know, Dallas. Actually, I do. Okie dokie. Ba-do. Alright, get that smelting. Why is my nose so itchy? It's whenever I'm streaming. I don't know why. Like, I know it looks occasionally like I'm picking my nose when I do that, and I'm genuinely not. It's just sometimes like the slate inside of my nostril and the outside. I just constantly keep scratching it. Don't know why. Don't know why. Okay. Let's make some brick blocks. I hate this phone, I swear to God. Why? What is wrong with the frames, genuinely? Do I need to reduce the simulation distance? Will that fix it? Because my simulation distance always has been fine, but I feel like... Nope, that won't change it. Okay, well, I don't really know what to do there now. A bit odd. Render distance. I could change my render distance. Maybe. Would that make a difference? I don't know. I don't know what half of these things even mean, to be honest with you. Sometimes I play games, my allergies act up even after I take my meds. I don't know why. That's a bit odd. I don't even think it's an allergy. I don't think I've got, like, hay fever or something. But something's not right. Fucking hell, it's so far to go down here now. Sheesh! God, my nose! Stop! Fucking hell! It's so bad, I don't even know why. I should just put, like, something over my nose so I can't itch it. Put one of those, like, Groucho Marx masks on with, like, the fake nose, and that way I can't scratch it. Done. Right, so you're saying in this general area there could be some more diamonds. The biggest Ralcord shaft ever recorded. It is a big shaft. We have got a big shaft here. You know? You know when you start, it's a big shaft moment? What the fuck? Oh, I set an alarm to remind me about sponsorship. It plays Dawn FM by the weekend. That's cool. Hang on, did that just... Oh my god, it just broke Spotify on my computer. Ha! For fuck's sake. There we go. Fixed. That's hilarious. Oh, Snip has given up though now. Probably because it switched devices. Reboot the bot. Mm-hmm, 9 to 5 just to get by. Alright, there we go. I don't think we're going to see any more diamonds in this vicinity, chat. Or don't think so. We live in a society, chat. To get you by tomorrow. Did not think tracing a mask would have been rolled out of context so soon. What, Ezra actually remembered the password for that account? Wow, fucking hell. That's a shocking moment. That account was goated before Ezra stopped uploading stuff on there, just saying. And there were so many good clips that she never put up there. Sad, you know? My humor was wasted. As if I just got this ping. Special offer today only. 50% off Tinder Gold. How about you stream more? How about you go back and upload the clips you should have uploaded? And how about you hang out on more streams then and moderate more, Ezra? You say I should stream more, but when I stream, you're not here half the time. You know? Tinder have actually sent me an offer saying get half off Tinder Gold. Wait, get 50% off your first 3 months instead of 55 quid, it's 27.50. Do you know what? I'm fucking good, thanks. That is a ridiculous amount of money. No. Fuck right off. My last ex I only met because I fucking used a boost on Tinder. And I question sometimes whether it was a good thing that I met her. Ha ha ha. Laugh, chat. All I can do is laugh at this point. Lol. Paying money for Tinder. Yeah, it's just not, it's not rated. What I do is Google does like those survey things and you can make money sometimes from answering surveys, so I buy Tinder stuff using those. Because I refuse to pump loads of money into Tinder. I'm good, thanks. But take that, Troy's last ex. You a bit... Oh, she was. Let's not go there. I'm not one to start, you know, catfights and stuff. But There's a reason I'm not in contact with her anymore, and the reason that the last message I sent her was about 1,000 words long, and she read and never came back to you because she kind of was like, yeah, that's valid, I can't really fight back to that. Because, oh, the story I could tell there, but for the sake of protecting my own privacy, I'm not going to. But let's say she was not a nice person, I told her that, she never replied to me again. sometimes people are not nice, chap. Sometimes people are not nice. What can you do? What's the RAL out of context Twitter handle? Ezra? What is it? I think it's just RAL OOC, but I don't know for sure. Ezra can tell you. Pained, confused, laughter. That's a mood. That is a mood, honestly, Dominic. If you relate, subscribe to Red Archer Live today. Thank you. Oh, it's at no context RAL. There you go, I'm an idiot. You don't know me. Fucking tune! Tune. Ugh. This whole album is so, like, Avril Lavigne inspired, to be honest. I'm apparently following already, that's cool. Yeah, but you wouldn't know, because Ezra basically just stopped posting on there, so. I would sub, but I'm trying this new thing called being poor. Oh, how's that working out for you, bro? That sounds cool. Sorry, I can't say that even for a joke. No, honestly, it's what I always say. Only subscribe if you can afford it. Genuinely. If you can afford to and you want to support me, please subscribe. If you can't, perfectly valid. Plus, you can always get gifted subs, you know? A lot of people who are subscribed often get gifted it by other people, and it's nice. I should post more on that. You should, Ezra. You should also moderate more. Have you considered that? Oh, no. See, guys, she's too busy going recording MGR no damage runs while I'm streaming. It's just sad. Me, you don't know me, you don't know me. And I'll do whatever I want to. Cause I'm a psycho, that's fine. So you better get out of my way. Is this the Shadow the Hedgehog theme song, question mark? It's not doing too well, but you know, never mind. Honestly, yeah, really. I gave the account details to Elian at some point, so blame him. Wow, you offloaded work onto him? You already did that with moderating, Ezra. You can't do it with everything else. Come on. Come on. No, the fuck you didn't. Oh, hang on a minute. Hang on a fucking minute. Oh. Drama. Chat, we've got drama. What is up, Drama Alert Nation? I'm your host, Red Archer Live. Let's get right into the mod fight. I like how this became a 3x3 tunnel at some point. I don't know when that happened, but... Oh! Oh! Ding-a-ling-a-ling-a-ding-a-ding-dong! Hinga-dinga-durgan! Here we go! Let's fucking go! Isn't that something SpongeBob said? Hinga-dinga-durgan. Swear it was. Oh! Oh! Ooh! 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 It's just him. It's just two diamonds. Well, you know what? It's fine. It's fine. It's better than nothing. We got two diamonds. We got two. We need one more, and then we're good. I want, you know, enough for an extra pickaxe in case we ever need it. You know, hopefully we won't, but we might. Fight, 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 kiss, kiss, kiss. They might do either of them, who knows? No, hang on, Ezra's got a girlfriend. We can't say that. Swear I put the account details on the mod chat at least. I don't remember you doing that. Maybe you did, but I don't know. Really bad diamond veins tonight. I know, yeah. You know, it's just really put, it's just a really bad, you know. I was going to try and make some kind of vein joke, but I couldn't. Not going to be kissing. Dom, just because you've got a girlfriend, okay? You know, not sadly, not everyone is in that position, okay, bro? You know? Don't make us all feel sad. Don't make us all feel sad, you know? Elian when the sheep rejects him. I just needed you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Elian. Sorry. Right, what time are we at? Right, 9:06, so I have to wrap up at some point shortly. It's also a good point Troy gets me a girlfriend and then complains when I don't show up. Oh, yeah, yeah, great, thanks, yeah. So are you just telling everyone now that that's what happened? I didn't think you were telling anyone. But yeah, that's fine. I did. I played a part in Ezra and getting a girlfriend. It was an epic gamer moment, but yeah. Ezra's like, yeah, now you wonder why I don't show up. Well, you know what? Maybe you could show up just every once in a while, just as a thank you, okay? All right? Okay? She even bought me birthday-themed sugar cookie. Okay, I want that. I want that. Curse of Troy can get other people girlfriends, but not himself. Yes. He could save others from death, but not himself. Can someone else pretend to be me for a day and then, like, message me and be like, hey, let me set you up with that girl? To be fair, there's not even anyone that I really want to get with at the minute, so. And it's not really shit you can force, to be honest. I guide others. Yes, that's a much better fucking meme reference, Chris. I guide others to a treasure I cannot possess. It's brilliant. But that does sound like you're possessing girls, which is also a bit sus. So, wow, Chris. Wow. Wow. I can, but I'll commit major tax fraud in your name. Please don't do that. Please don't do that. Thank you. Just ask David. Yeah, you're a great wingman, aren't you? Aren't you, Chris? Yeah. Remind me, who's David dating again? Oh, yeah. Ral Jail Arc. Welcome to my Twitch live stream, live from prison! Woo! Fucking hell. You know what? It's funny that I'm glad I set reminders for this video call, because I've not had a single email reminder like, hey, you've got this meeting in half an hour or something. Who's David dating his left hand? I was going to make that joke, but I refrained, Elian. But I appreciate you making it, because I didn't want the joke to go to waste. Can I just say, I've been wearing one sock now for the last, like, half an hour. It's very weird. I'm taking my other sock off. Oh, this is really difficult under a desk. It's actually his right hand. Valid. He's not here. Yeah, we know he's not here, because I played the 1984 song, and he wasn't here to react. Actually, Ezra, just at him and say I said he's a bitch. Give him context if you want, but no. And tell him to join the stream if he wants context. And he'll be like, oh. Can't even defend himself. He never can. He's from Manchester. Come on. Fucking poor Manchester boy. He's already living in a third world. I'm sorry. I can't make those jokes. Genuinely, Manchester is a nice city. We make loads of jokes about it, but I like Manchester. I had to go there to see Pale Waves, you know? So it can't all be that bad. Manchester moment. I like how that's became like kind of a half meme. Manchester moment. Birmingham is worse. Again, I can't say much about Birmingham. The only times I've been to Birmingham are to Cadbury World and to Comic Con. I've not really experienced the city itself. If Chris wants to give me a tour sometime, I'll come. No. I do have a friend who lives in Birmingham. And I've constantly said I was going to go over there and hang out with her, but we never got around to it because of COVID and shit. If that ever does happen, then I'll tell you what I actually think of Birmingham. Who knows? Come city centre, there's like a couple HMVs. Oh, I'm sold. When and where? I like how the snipbot again has just given up. I drove into Birmingham and it was grim, not gonna lie. Amelia's still here. She's just listening. She's just lurking. Why don't you talk more, pal? Why don't you talk more? I want more people in the chat for me to read things out. Why don't you talk more? You bitch. I'm joking. Why was Birmingham grim? What was grim about Birmingham? Share the details. Give us the scoop. What happened? I am being bullied for being a Brummie. I mean, it's not a new thing for you, unfortunately. I can't say it's a new thing. You're now lurking. Wow! I'm playing Portal. Excuse me, how dare you? How about you get a portal to some bitches? I'm sorry. Troy Sexism. I'm not sexist! What the fuck do you mean? We're not even joking about that. Just the name itself is bad enough. Birmingham. That's a weird name. Why is every time it's only one or two diamonds? I swear to fuck. Every time. My frames! Portal some bitches, I'm screaming. Oh, did you really like that, did you? Thanks, I'm proud of that one. When you get that portal, can I use it as well, though, please? I'd really appreciate it. Thanks. So Birmingham is a weird name, but Manchester isn't. What about Liverpool? The Pool of Livers? Ew. Who the fuck came up with that one? Liverpool's a great city, but that's got a weird name. It sounds fine when you say Liverpool, but when you actually think of it as Liverpool, it is a bit odd. It's a bit bizarre, you know? Motherfuckers live in Manchester. They do. Motherfuckers do live in Manchester. It's wild, you know? I forgot about Hull. I think most people did. Don't worry about it. No. Try explaining clan fair pugwilligigilligogogogogogogogogogogogogogogogogog the drop willigninsingogogogog. How was that? I did try. I don't think it was that great. But how was that? How was that? Liverpool is not a great city. Newcastle, however, is even worse. The birthplace of man's greatest weakness. The people who will one day bring this world to its knees. The Geordies. I'm sorry, no, they're lovely people. We like Geordies. Anton Decker Geordie, they're very cool. You know, why Iron Man, Saturday Night Takeaway, innit? I'm going to miss Saturday Night Takeaway because of the charity stream. Wow. You all better do the same thing, you know? Watch the charity stream instead. Record Saturday Night Takeaway. Charity stream is temporary. Saturday Night Takeaway is forever. The entire Welsh language was created when a man threw a typewriter off a cliff. Why is that so funny to me? Why is that so funny? That should not be funny. Hooray, pet. Why, I, man. Welcome to Saturday Night Takeaway. The only show on telly that says, Joe, just watch the adverts. Where? Okay. It was made by a trained gorilla. Okay, that's the, we're getting too mean to the Welsh now, okay? You know, first we say they shag sheep. Now we say that their language is shit. Come on. Say how you did. You almost completely failed that pronunciation, although you pretty much got the last syllable. Yeah, I know it's go-go-goch. I know that's how it ends. Go-go-goch. Goch. Just sound like you're throwing up and that works. Goch. Want to go to the shop in Welsh is... What the fuck? Is that actually... Oh, no, it's not. Because you put Asda's... Oh, Asda's... You want to go to Asda in Welsh? It's like the thing is, I could say to Elian, hey, translate this sentence. He probably just translated to something that we wouldn't know. Because who speaks Welsh in 2022, honestly? Imagine speaking Welsh. What the fuck? Fucking weird language. No. That's the thing. There are a lot of languages that just sound wildly different. And, you know, we make jokes, but there are. It is cool that there are so many languages. The only thing that sucks about languages, like, for me, is that, you know, it sucks when you can't understand what people are talking about and you want to know, like... You want to know more about people, but if they don't talk in your language, it's hard to understand them, obviously. But it's cool for the sake of culture that there are so many different people who speak, who say different things, have different accents, different languages. It's what makes us all unique. Jimmy Carr spoke about the Welsh and it was so true I was dying. Did he speak about tax dodging? Or the weird laugh he has? It was like a fucking, someone pumping up a balloon with like force. You ever heard Jimmy Carr laugh? Seriously. Man's laugh is wilding. Man's got a fucking weird laugh. I don't even know whether I want to read that all out because I know what it means. I basically just said dick. Is it about dick? Who knows? Me when I forget my name. SpongeBob when he lost his identity. Who am I? Has he even apologized for that one joke yet? Which one? Which one? Aren't there multiple? Speak Welsh for half an hour? No. Absolutely not. You could not... I will not sully my tongue with that language. So I like how... This is the problem. I'm a very sarcastic person. You lot know this. And I worry sometimes that my sarcasm comes out to be mean. Literally in Who's There, there's a couple of times where I just shit on Crispy for a joke. And I worry that there'll be new people who haven't heard me before and will think, wow, this Troy guy is an absolute dickhead. I'll be like, I promise, I'm not really a dick. I just like to make jokes, you know? It's just jokes. It's just jokes. Aren't you? I'm not a dickhead. What do you mean? Don't be mean. Can you not post slurs? Wait, what? What did he say? Oh yeah, you can't use that anymore. It's not a very, well, I say anymore like it was alright before, but it's not a typically used term, Stu. To be fair, Ezra, I know people who didn't know that, so I would benefit the doubt on that one. Yeah, see. Who's there? The best brutally British and annoying Australian combo. Yes, you know, brutally British and annoyingly Australian. I like it. I like it. I can post slurs. You can't. No, you can't. Done so many fucking bits in this mine now. Blimey. Well, we didn't build a house, but we did a lot of mining, and we got 6 diamonds. So, that's progress. You know, that is progress. So, let's get back up and store some shit. Fucking hell, this shaft went on for miles. We have a massive shaft, chat. Have you seen how massive this shaft is? How many times are we going to make this joke before it gets really annoying, you know? Wait, what? Alien deleted... Wait, what? Oh, for the record, Chris put sheep shagger. See, now it's in the VOD forever, Elian. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Fucking hell. What a massive shaft. What a massive shaft this is. We live in a shaft society. All right. Badoom. Badoom. We need more coal. It's going to need to be a goal for the next stream, getting more coal. All right. So, that is probably a good point to wrap this stream up. It's been fun. This is what I said. The thing I like about Minecraft is it is very much just like a switch off your brain, chat, and play in the background kind of game. You know? And it makes it a more relaxing experience for me. And it's also been nice to not look at the viewing figures. I'm gonna see them now and check who I can raid. So I hope that they're not too bad. But if they are, then they are. At least I didn't know during the stream. There's only 8 people here. Well, what can you do? What can you do? I would have hoped there'd be a few more than that. But you know what? The thing that's nice is that there were people interacting in the chat constantly. That's what makes the difference. When there's not many people watching and there's no one talking in the chat, it's like, well, okay. You know? Half the enjoyment for me is interacting with the chat. So if people weren't reading the chat, that would be what would upset me a lot. So I'm glad that at the very least we had people interacting, so that's nice. But then again, I haven't seen any viewing average or anything like that, and that's why I kept it off, because I just didn't want to know. You know, I just did not want to know. I didn't want to look. I figured, why would I want to do that? So, oh, what the fuck?
Go to Horny Old Road.
No, Horny Old Road, that's weird. There was an advert for Channel 4 on this Twitch I was loading up, and it was literally just for a second, I couldn't unmute it fast enough. It was the fucking weatherman reading Clangfair, but the fucking Welsh town's name. I don't like that. Why was that the advert? That scared me. That has actually just scared me. Why was that the fucking advert? Twitch is watching us. Twitch is watching us, chat. It's watching us. I don't like it. I don't like it at all. And I've seen the ad before, but I just kind of forgot that was a thing that happened in it. Oh yeah, also, do you notice I'm wearing a Pale Wave shirt, Ezra? Oh, my camera's completely slowed down. Holy shit, we're in like 2 FPS. Oh, and it's frozen. Boom. But I've got a Pale Wave shirt on. There you go. It's got a skull. It's got a skull on it, but you can't really see because the camera's frozen. Hey, camera, do you want to unfreeze for a second? Please? I'm holding my shirt up and I'd really like it if people could actually see the design I was holding up. I'm going to give up in a second. There we go. The camera froze again, but you can see it. There you go. It's got a skull. Got a skull. I thought you'd find that enjoyable. Anyway, I'm going to pause the stream and then I can just hit play once I raid. Yeah, there we go. Cool. So, thank you all very much for watching. I do appreciate it. I will be back tomorrow with something. Fuck knows what. But I appreciate you all hanging out. It's been nice. It's been a good time. And it's nice. Nice, quiet Minecraft vibes. We'll be back with some more Minecraft next week. Alrighty. So, until then, thank you all for hanging out. I greatly appreciate you, and I'll see you with whatever the fuck I stream tomorrow. Who knows? Probably should have done Payday this week, but I normally do that on a Wednesday. So, fuck it. I don't know. We'll see. I will see you all tomorrow for another stream, and then don't forget Saturday, 7 PM UK time, be the charity stream raising money for Games for Love. Please hang out. It will be a good time. I'm sure we'll all have fun. So let's go raid John. We're going to raid Rusty Chains. He's playing Kingdom Hearts, because when isn't he playing Kingdom Hearts? Let's go watch and have fun. We've got to raid now. Right now. Bye.